are you gonna see a gap that big? Dude, this is Nitro Rallycross. Let's get ready to send it! How we doing out there, Nitro fans across the globe? Super excited to be here. Look at this playground. This is Utah Motorsports Campus. Excited to be here. I'm Jared Deanna. Joining me is Andrew Coley. Andrew Coley joining us from all the way across the pond. I'm American. He is definitely from the UK. But you know what? Nitro Rallycross speaks internationally. That's right.
Well, we're going to be speaking internationally next year. 10 rounds next year going around the world. 5 rounds this year in the USA. We've had 2 here previously at Utah Motorsport Campus. Great to be back here. I kind of feel like we're kicking off the championship in the spiritual home of Nitro Rallycross with that great big gap jump right outside our window. So really, really looking forward to this.
Yeah, 2018, 2019, I was not here, a standalone event. And now we're talking about a 5-stop championship kicking off here, as you say, kind of the birthplace of Nitro Rallycross. And now we are looking at our Nitro Rallycross qualifying battle brackets. And we are seeing, again, our number 1 and number 2 qualifier, essentially a bye run. Timmy will meet either Liam Doran or Travis Pastrana. You can see him over there. Scott Speed will go against Andreas Backrud or Kevin Hansen. Then the other gentlemen down at the bottom, they're going to be going against each other. We'll see where they land. And like you said, tennis or drifting or whatever, you'll see the final two, the battle of the ages. But then this is just shaping things up for tomorrow.
Yeah, it's cool, isn't it? We're doing all this action today, and it's just to get us to the grids ready to go racing tomorrow. So tomorrow is racing all day long. We got 2 heats where the top 2 go through. Then we got 2 quarterfinals. And we've got a last chance qualifier as well. So we're going to get 10 cars through to a 6-lap final tomorrow. And an advantageous grid position is really important. You know, if you can get this top qualifier spot by winning that final battle, Jared, you're inside in Heat 1 tomorrow, and you could book a place straight into the final.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about advantage. And the advantage is, you know, are you a better driver? How's your vehicle set up? How does it compare for this course? And again, this is round 1 of 5, but the variable that's all the same are the tires. They all run the same tire, Yokohama tires. And how aggressive is this track? Laying down the blue groove, that's where the rubber meets the dirt and the blue groove. But you know what? Todd Richards found out some more about Yokohama tires.
Over here with some of the unsung heroes of Nitro Rallycross in the Yokohama booth. And I've got Dwayne, the tire guy. Now, Dwayne, we have here example A. That is not what a rim is supposed to look like after a race. Tell us why you guys are so important and what this does when that happens to a wheel.
Well, you know, there's kind of basic physics and just kind of certain things that a tire can and cannot do. This situation was contact with the K-rail in the middle of a corner. The tire still did hold air, but obviously the wheel's done and the tire that was connected to it is done. So, you know, just we're trying our best to do what we can and make these guys go as fast as they can, as safe as they can. And there's just certain, you know, it's racing. Things happen.
Nitro RX is brought to you by Yokohama Tire. Make every drive a performance. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. And by the Utah Sports Commission. Utah, the state of sport.
There it is. We're seeing the history just unfold before our eyes and making history today as the battle brackets are upon us. First ever Nitro Rallycross Supercars battle brackets. So we are seeing Timmy Hansen, he is your number 1 qualifier. With us having 14 vehicles, we are going to be seeing our number 1 and number 2 qualifying driver have a bye run, essentially, into the next bracket.
Yeah, so they can take it easy. Yesterday, they were discussing whether or not they might be allowed to just, you know, drive off at the end of the straight, take the start and bail out. But they changed the regs and said, no, you know what, you've got to do the 3 laps. But, Jared, this isn't about time, it's about taking the win. So when there's 2 cars in there, you come home first, you win. So it doesn't matter if the track conditions change for everybody else. It's not about the timing, it's about the P1 to go forward. So I think you'll find the guys you've got to buy, unless they're desperate to test something on the car, potentially, you know, they're not going to go around slowly, but you won't see any risk taking from them.
Yeah, and the other thing here is about getting familiarity with the track. So I think you know, we were saying, why would you run? Just pull them off to the side. No, I think this is, they're getting more track time, getting familiar with the course overall and how it's changing, how it's being dynamic. There is the number 199, Travis Pastrana. That's a flying squirrel on the back of his helmet. Is he the flying squirrel here this weekend, the plaided one? And Liam Doran, the British bomb, number 33, there in the background as we are getting prepared to see Timmy Hansen. He'll run first. Again, he'll complete his three runs, but he will advance on into the next bracket.
So looking back at Timmy's times during the course of the weekend, Gerald, I was looking, he's been right up at the top of the timesheets in pretty much every session. I think he was P2 in practice one, he was P1 in practice two. He then won the solo qualifying as well. So he's absolutely on it. And what's interesting about Timmy's car is actually it's a little bit of a hybrid. They only had three cars. Two of them are taking part in the World Championship at the minute. The third car was shipped over here for Kevin. And they built Timmy a bit of a hybrid.
Yeah.
So we'll have a chat about that when we see him out on his run, because he's going to have a bye. We're going to have three laps to talk about him. Liam going through those final bits of prep. If ever you're at a rallycross event, if you can get in the pre-grid where these guys are now, the atmosphere is intense. It's just great. It's that bit where they're putting on the helmet, pulling on your various different straps and tightening up your helmet. You know, it's good to go. Another man who's getting good to go there. You can see him. Travis Pastrana is with Katie Osborne now.
That's right. He's putting on those gloves. He's getting geared up here. It all comes down to this for today. What's it going to take?
It's going to take a lot, man. Every driver here is absolutely awesome. So I saw the brackets. I was like, oh, man, I'm against Liam. And then I looked at all the other ones, Baccaroots against Hansen. And I'm like, oh, this is just knockdown, drag out. So cool. We might not have picked the best round in qualifying, but what should do better?
Hey, he knows what it takes around here. If anybody knows this track, guys, it's Travis Pastrana.
So Pastrana saying that he'd maybe gone on the wrong route. And what he means by that is earlier on he took the tabletop. He obviously thought that taking the tabletop would maybe give him a quick enough lap time, but it didn't. So I think we can expect people to be taking the gap for the quick lap. Is there I can't see people going for the tabletop. I think potentially whoever loses the start, bear in mind, unfortunately, the first thing you're going to see is a bye. So you're seeing Timmy Hansen get a bye. He's going to do these three laps. Normally we'd be seeing a battle here with two cars. So Timmy can afford to cruise about. He might do a launch, I think, just get a feel for the grip levels. Remember, they're going to want to get the RPM right. There's a bunch of data to get ready for tomorrow. Racing is at a similar time tomorrow, so they can be gathering a bit of data on how to get that car off the line. So Timmy with the green light, and in fact, he doesn't do a launch. So Timmy's not even going to do that, Jared. He's going to chill, and we're going to chill as well. So
yeah.
We'll take a look at Timmy doing three laps, and unless something incredible happens, we'll see you for battle two.
Yeah, let's lay back and listen to the sound of the sports and listen to the exhaust note of Timmy Hansen, your number one qualifier. Three laps, having a go here at Utah Motorsports Campus. That is the Joker lap.
Yokohama Joker lap. In he goes. Look at Jared. He's fully cruising. You know, he's fully cruising. But the thing is, they don't miss a trick.
No.
I'm not going to use tyres. They've all got a limited number of tyres. If it's super hot tomorrow and this track rubbers in, they're going to want the newest boots they can get on that car for every run. He's not even doubling the double. Super chill.
Yep.
What we expected, I think.
Yeah, and we're going to see three laps of this. This is pretty much just to ensure that the vehicle's up to snuff, it's running, and he is capable of having a battle against either Doran or Pastrana in the eight. The bracket of eight. So Timmy Hansen, one run and done. Two more to go for Timmy Hansen. Maybe at speed, maybe not. For our North American viewers, this vehicle isn't manufactured in the States. What vehicle are we looking at?
This is a Peugeot 208. So Peugeot is a French manufacturer, an old, very old French manufacturer. They were a factory team in the World Rallycross Championship for a few years. The Hansens, who were driving for that factory team along with Sebastian Loeb, have continued to use it and continued to develop it. It had a little bit of a dip in form, to be fair, Jared. You know, they weren't keeping up with some of the other factory teams, but they've dug their heels in, they've got it done. Timmy Hansen won the 2019 World Championship in an incredible finale with Andreas Backrud, which has left those two as as pretty bitter rivals at times, and their fans, you know, their fans, they're like Hamilton and Verstappen fans or Senna and Prost. You know, you like one or you like the other.
They double down.
Yeah, but you know what? They're both great guys. They're both epic drivers. And, yeah, of course I want to see some more battles between them. So, you know, just enjoy these guys for what they do. And this isn't normally what they do. This is cruise control on. Because Timmy's just saving everything for the next race. You know, as Travis said, this field's stacked. And yeah, look at that battle in the background, Liam versus Travis. You know, that's, I can't wait.
And that's what we'll be seeing next here. So kind of warming things up with a little lukewarm water, but we'll be turning up the heat in just a little bit. So we create a big dirt bath and dust bowl. So it looks like Timmy Hansen maybe airing out a little bit. Also, you know, maybe being kind and not trashing the course as well. All right, well, we're watching Timmy do his thing. She is with the golden child, Tanner Faust.
The golden child, if you can take a look here, this rockster has definitely turned to gold, but the side of it still looks like it's banged up a little bit. First, Tanner, how's the car coming together after that qualifying?
I'm good. I hit the wall. I guess I wasn't the only one, but I hit the wall in the bowl turn, and that got a puncture out of that, ended up piecing together a lap still after it. So I think we dodged a bullet a little bit and got fourth out of that somehow. But puts us against Oliver over here, who I remember running around as like a 6-7-year-old in the woods when I was racing in Europe. He's Andreas' son, so it's super cool to be racing against him here in this kind of format.
You know, one of the things I think is interesting, you're talking about these young guns over here. Cabot Bigham is another guy. You are actually still learning. You told me earlier today you're learning this car. And so as these guys might be a little bit younger than you, you're still having to learn.
Yeah, no offense taken. Yes, I'm. No, I am, of course. This is the second day in the car, and it's been great. I mean, Dreyer Reinbold and EKS have put together a pretty awesome little machine. It goes really quick, and this is definitely not the type of track this car is used to running. It's used to running in European championships. But it's adapting well. It works well with the Yokohama tires. And this track is changing every single time you go out there. So it's really about me adapting to the track. And that's, I'm learning every lap, like you said.
All right, well, best of luck out there. Stay safe, guys.
Let's get geeky for a second. That is the chassis that Mattias Ekström won the World Rallycross Championship in 2016. It's not the same spec. They've all been updated to as close to the latest spec as they can get. Liam Doran is actually in the latest spec of car. You know, British driver, chassis number 007.
Gotta love it. So the Monster Energy RX Cartel, Liam Doran. I know his wife and kids are here in the building, but he's got a lot of fans back in the UK, including James. How are we doing there? Drama James, Jimmy Drama. As we are now seeing TP, Travis Pastrana, as he said, anybody is a competitor here. So format here, three laps. Each driver does need to take their Joker lap. Strategy, do they take the Joker lap out of the gate or do they save it for the final lap?
I think if you lose the start, the sensible thing to do is to go Joker immediately. That's what I'd be looking to do. But we'll see. Let's hope somebody decides to go side by side over the big gap jump, because that's what we all want to see.
I can't wait.
Dude, if you're going to pick two people who might do it, Liam Doran and Travis Pastrana, they'd be like,
two are psychos.
They'll probably race together and take the Joker together on the last lap, to have a three-lap race. So, yeah, here we go. Proper battle for the first time. Doran anti-lag on each side of the grid. Oh, takes the clutch.
Travis gets the jump.
Yeah, Travis got a great start there. Subaru been testing jumps, starts extensively. They've been testing with Scott Speed, and it looks like they got it dialed. It's a real shame for Liam, they're having to dip the clutch.
That's right. All right, so well executed there by Travis Pastrana. He normally doesn't get the jump. He says he doesn't get the best start, and Liam goes for the Joker. That's exactly what he talked about. If you don't get that jump, maybe go for the Joker. Nice, clean landing there by Pastrana as we go under the bridge where he drew some blood or drew some dust.
So let's get into tactics straight away in terms of Joker lap. So Travis has a choice now. If he feels he's fine, faster than Liam, he'll stay out until the last lap and then he'll Joker. But for safety, and if he thinks Liam might close that gap down, and when you run wide like that, if I were Travis' spotter, I'd be going, you know what, Joker on the next lap, because it gives Liam less laps to try to close the gap. So Travis may well respond with a Joker straight away. Remember, the winner goes through, the loser's done for the day, and there's a championship point for every battle you win.
And six, yeah, a championship, that is a great point. And even with those by runs, we saw Timmy Hansen, 6.5 seconds between the two drivers. Liam really needs to get some gusto here and go for it. And we are seeing 7 seconds. So that gap is growing. What is Travis going to do?
Yeah, is Travis going to go Joker or not? No, he's got Travis. Nope. Yes, he is.
There he is.
Travis goes Joker. So splits off to the right. So now watch for Liam in the background. The gap was 7.1. Doran now coming up towards the big gap jump. Pastrana goes underneath. Going to come up for the merge. Where's Doran in the Audi?
Coming up
for the inside line, but Pastrana's got it easily. So 7.1. Let's see what the gap
is
now.
Wide swing by Travis.
And Liam with a half spin in the background. So I was keen to see the gap, but with the mistakes from Liam, you can't. So that doesn't give us a delta. I reckon 5 seconds looking at that, Jared. I think five could be about right for Supercar.
Travis, he took a weird line, kind of got hung out there to drive. But Liam, as you said, kind of did a mid-spin, saved it, salvaged a run there. But look, it's shrinking, 3.86 seconds from Travis to Liam Doran.
Travis could just keep the door shut, though. You know, this is the thing. Now, a pass is hard work anyway. See the white flag? That's just to let you know you're on your last lap. Liam's a long, long way back. So interesting that Travis responded on lap two. I wonder, without the mistake after the step up, maybe he wouldn't have done. The other thing is, I'm not sure the spotters can see the backside of the course, so they may not have known that. And also, sometimes the driver chooses the Joker strategy for themselves, particularly if you're in a turn one fight.
And it looks like Travis has worked out his kinks, right? It seems like the car is running better. He's running clean. He's running tidier. Tires are staying within his vehicle. You know, we're talking about deep beating. But also, let it be known, one and done. You know, if you lose, you're out. This is moving on. This is bracket style, and you can accumulate more points as you progress through the brackets.
It's four championship points, Jared. You know, we talked earlier about Backwood losing the World Championship to Hansen on countback. They were on equal points. You go and ask him, and he'll tell you all the points where he missed out on one point. And it's not lost on these drivers. Get every point you can. So Travis is going to go through. He's going to take a championship point. Liam Doran, I'm afraid, is going to be done for today.
What are you afraid of?
Well, I'm disappointed Liam's going to win.
Liam's still going to have a smile on his face, talking to him. It seems like he's having a ball. But guess what? Travis Pastrana wins this battle. First ever making history here, our bracket battle here at Nitro Rallycross Supercars. Congratulations to him. Yeah, unfortunately, Liam, you know, I think Travis opened the door of opportunity, but Liam, unfortunately, closed the door and said, go ahead, man. So, and here is the bracket as we take a look overall. So you can see Timmy Hansen with that number one qualifying position. He advances on, and then you are seeing Travis Pastrana. Yeah, look at that. Timmy Hansen and number 199, Travis Pastrana, will go against each other, and this is how it got done. Next up, Tanner Faust, Ollie Erickson. Love how he talks about it. Maybe that's throwing a little bit of shade where he says, I remember him 6 years old running around the forest, and now he's going toe-to-toe. But look at this, Travis Pastrana and Liam, this is how it got done.
Liam, it was the start, I'm afraid, Jared. So yeah. The thing is here, it's pretty hard in terms of trying to figure out what RPM you want. So, you know, the tires are sticky. The track's hot, particularly that tarmac section. I don't know what the track temperature is, but you need the RPM just right. Too high and you get too much wheel spin, too low and you bog. And on this occasion for Liam, it was probably 100, 200 RPM too low, but it didn't work out. Subaru, all that start testing looks to have paid off. That used to be their big weakness, but the WRX STI killed it off the start there. Great job.
Yeah, that was smooth like butter there. You could see him touching down, really compressing all of that suspension, and that is when he got the checkered flag. And you can see our next two competitors waiting in the wings. We're talking about that of Faust and Ollie Erickson. And there's Pastrana down there. And looks like he's worked it out. But guess what? Next battle for him will be Timmy Hansen. Speaking of next battle, we move on to the Golden Child, and he earned that nickname after drifting for numerous years, went over to Rallycross and won at X Games. So right now, Tanner Faust and Ollie Erickson getting that launch. Let's see how they go. Are they going to Joker lap? Are they going for the standard? Let's see how they go in that first turn. Here we go, Andrew Coley.
Faust got the start there, didn't he? Erickson's tucked up behind. So if this is a traditional approach, I think you'll see Erickson go Joker, but watch for the split here. Erickson's going Joker. You can see the rotation on the car on the way into the corner. He had it rotated more so that he'll go Joker straight away. Faust now responds or doesn't. Yeah, I'll tell you what, this is quite a cool way for us at least to teach people if they're new to Rallycross how the tactics work. Because when there's seven cars, the tactics aren't quite so obvious. Yeah. When there's just the two, this is how you're looking at. Spotters will be going nuts with a stopwatch trying to figure out what that gap is and whether it's going up or down.
Perspective. And did you see he was flirting with the skirting up there? He absolutely, you know, the 007 of chassis code of Liam Doran. Looks like Tanner Faust is more James Bond-esque because he threw the smoke screen. That's going to be difficult to see through.
He went all Aston Martin on us, didn't he? You know, at the top of the berm. So here comes Faust now. Let's get a good idea. Remember, Erickson was right on him. So this will give us another good idea of what the benchmark is on the Joker, and it's 4.6. So 4.6 seconds. Will Faust respond this time? Or is he going to wait until the last lap? So watch for Faust. He's going to go standard lap. So Faust thinks he's quicker, and he's going to hold on till that last lap. So now we need to watch that gap back to Ericsson.
Here we go. So Tanner Faust, watch how high. See if he does it again. He was so high on that bank. All the photographers are like, thanks, Tanner. Really, bro? You broke my Canon lens.
They'll be getting those fancy little paintbrushes out, the ones they do. You know the ones I mean? Just going to dust off the big guns.
So last lap should be very interesting. So 5.25 seconds. They estimate about 3 seconds for that Joker lap, longer. So the gap could, Ericsson, though. Look at spinning a lot of tire.
I think it's close to five. Ericsson was 4.8 off the back of Faust on that last time. And we previously we thought the same. Faust has just edged it out of 5.2, now 5.4. Yeah, I think the mistake from Ericsson there is going to cost him any chance of nicking it at the merge.
So look at this. Let's see the time split here. And like you said, about 5 seconds, and that is 5.9. It's going to get hairy here. So look at Tanner Faust pushing the tires out of the way. He does have to go in the Joker lap. Make sure he does hit it. If he doesn't, he'd be penalized, but no, he does get it. So Tanner Faust, let's see this, Coley. What do you think?
I think Faust has got this, but Faust has also clipped the tires, and the stewards can be notoriously a bit picky about that. It's close enough for Ericsson up the inside line, but he can't quite get it done. So 5.9 then is only just enough, Jared. Only just, so I reckon five. What do you think? Maybe a bit more.
Yeah, five, maybe 5.5 seconds. But Tanner Faust, he needs to keep this clean.
Yeah, he's tidy. He's patient.
Yeah, well done. Well done by Tanner Faust. And he's going against Ollie, who's definitely a fierce competitor. I mean, that car has proven Tanner Faust getting used to the car. You know, his words with Katie saying, hey, I'm just learning the car with every turn.
Ollie's is a brand new build as well. So brand new build for Ollie coming through in P2. But it's the 16 chassis, the world championship winning chassis of Ekstrom that wins this time in the hands of Faust. And Faust books his place in the quarterfinals. Ollie won't like that. He hates losing. Hates it.
I mean, who likes losing?
Nobody.
Yeah.
But you know,
it's just a dumb statement, Andrew. Why do you say that? Dude, I love losing. Losing's the best.
I get you. You wait.
They told us to have more fun with Nitro Rallycross.
Katie, go see Oliver. Go see Oliver. See how pleased he is.
Oh, that's so good. Oh, Ollie, yeah. Hey, Ollie, how'd you feel about losing?
It sucks.
Oh, man. So, yeah, first lap, Tanner went really wide. He saved it all the way till the end, and he kind of learned from his mistake there on that bank.
Yeah, he was tidy, wasn't he, on the remaining lap. Still, it'd say that there was a little tire tap. I don't know whether or not the stewards, I don't think they will, because I don't think he gained. If he'd gained enough time, if it had been super close between him and Ollie, super close, then maybe the stewards would step in. But I tell you what, Ollie was closer than I thought he would be. When you look how slow the Audi was coming out of the tunnel here, watch the traction though, Jared. Look at this. He actually hop jumps, comes in a little bit too soon. That gives him a bit of understeer and he would have had to wait on the throttle. But when he lights it up, the all-wheel drive just blasts him just out in front of Ollie Ericsson. They're such impressive machines.
Yep. All right, as we are wrapping up this battle here, Faust gets the win, but Katie's with Travis once again.
Yeah, some other guy who loves battle brackets is Travis Pastrana. You were just talking to Scott Speed and Andreas Bakkerud with a whole lot of hand motions. What were you telling them?
So in the far corner, the hairpin, you can no longer get to the bottom. Everyone's going to go straight. So I said, if you're angled inside of them, they can't block it and you can't stop. So what happens in the corner, well, hopefully doesn't stay in the corner, but at least it's going to be a good place to pass.
Hey, good insight as we kick off this next round.
Yeah, no, dude, it was great.
All right. We're just talking off camera here. As we go to our next battle, who do we have? Steve Arpin and Robin Larson. Robin, man, he was flying.
Larson's start was dialed there. He's going to try and get in front of Arpin. Shuts the door on him. Arpin can't quite find a way through. Arpin does go to the inside. Taps the tires. No room there. He's all over the back of Larson. Larson will rotate this tight on the inside. Oh, Arpin trying to find the traction. I think he'll go Joker again, but let's see if he bucks the trend. He doesn't. He goes Joker.
Ah, there you go. So Arpin, he just could not get around Robin. And look at this. The Yokohama Joker lap being utilized by Steve Arpin. And now they come into the bay. Ooh, look at Robin Larson. Remember, if you can recall, coming off that jump, he went to that wall earlier.
There's two places people are making mistakes, Jared, all the while. One is the first berm, and the second one is this jump into the braking zone in the hairpin. And it's good. I want to see the driver's challenge. That's what Travis said as well, and that's what gives us the opportunity for passing. Arpin's only 5.4 back. He'll want to close that down, see if Larson's feeling ballsy or not. If he is, he'll stay out. If he's not, he'll go defensive.
All right, Robin Larson. maybe learning from his mistakes earlier, said, hey, sit down now. Don't get too crazy, as there you see. And man, I loved how aggressive Arpin was out of the gate. He, you know, slammed into that tire wall. He's chomping right on Larson's heels.
He's closing him down. So it was 5.4, 5.2, it's 4.9. Larson needs to respond now because Arpin is quicker. Larson goes Joker, but he's sideways there. He has to wait on the throttle. Arpin can take this over the big gap jump.
Yep, this should be exciting here. Watch Larson now. He goes in, little squeal right there underneath the bridge.
He's done it.
Arpin gets the pass.
Easy.
Well executed, but now, again, he's got him right on his heels now. He's got to keep it clean.
This is what we were after. This is what we wanted. We wanted a tight race. And Larson, look, he's got the angle on the car. Watch for Larson maybe trying something sneaky on the hairpin here. Rotate it early. Oh, slide.
Nice.
Now they're
Arpin.
Tidy. They're both
that was
tidy.
Probably the best execution I've seen. Obviously, both the vehicles. But I got to say, Arpin was just that much crisper.
Yeah, Arpin's car's looking dialed underneath. Yeah. Lots of the teams have spoken about how they're having to dial into the fact this is like 90% loose.
Yeah.
It's very different from the European track. The traction is king here. You want good exit from everything. And look at Arpin's gap blasting here.
Yeah, we still got another lap here. So every single turn counts. Don't get loose. Don't get in that soot, you know, that silt. That's going to eat you up. The way Arpin is just whipping this car around is really masterclass. He's doing a really fine job. Here we go, over the jump one more time for these gentlemen. Well, last time for one of these gentlemen for today, at least. Look at Robin. Really a lot of air in between him and the vehicle.
Robin's tidy through there. We've seen two really different distinct lines through the banking, which is look at that. Yes, Larson.
That's what you're talking about.
Yeah, this is what I mean about him and Liam. There's a big competition about who's the sendiest, and the mistake from Arpin gets deep. Liam's nickname is Sendy McSenderson. You know, Larson is known for going backwards into pretty much anything it's possible to go backwards into. Yesterday, Liam's wife was like, well, yeah, you know, Liam was like, oh, I was really sideways, didn't I, babe? Just not as sideways as Larson.
Hey,
and he didn't like it.
Not your wife throwing shade like that? Come on, dude.
But it hasn't worked this time, has it? Larson sideways, not enough to beat Steve Arpin, and it's Arpin who takes it.
The Canadian Cowboy comes out on top. His number might be 00, but he is number one in this case against Robin Larson. So get this, Arpin and Faust will be going against each other. Former Ford teammates back in the day. It was like a Thursday, I think it was. That was the day. But let's take a look. This is how these gentlemen got it done. A great start there by Robin Larson.
Squeeze it. He went to shut the door. Larson, I reckon, looked in his mirror there because he squeezed and then squeezed back out again. So he maybe thought Arpin was just a foot closer than he actually was. Arpin then had a nose up the inside, but met the tire bales. Nah, not going to happen. So he goes Joker immediately. And look at the advantage he had. Larson coming out again with that bit of understeer. I wonder if cutting on. Look at Larson. Almost a wall tap for Larson on the exit.
Wow.
But Arpin had that done. Really good drive from Steve. Really good.
Yeah, you wonder what was going through Robin's head. He's like, I'm going to this Joker lap, coming out of this tunnel, and looks, you know, probably didn't see him because he's up to the right, and says, here comes Arpin, and drops in. So as Arpin and Larson, Katie, Arpin gets the win, but how did he do so well?
Hey, I think it has to do a whole lot with his dirt modified races that he's been running this last year. He's also really been working on these cars himself, so he's getting a whole lot of different experience than maybe some of these other guys. He actually told me that he hasn't been in a rallycross car since 2019 at Mid-Ohio, and he said, I actually went and drove it over here at the parking lot not too far away. So I really think it's a combination of that car underneath him being dialed, but it's also those technical skills that he's been gaining in his dirt racing.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Yeah. And again, might have to do with having a new baby, too. You know, just kind of like, you know, all things exist. This is racing, but I'm out here having fun. And you know, I think that's the fact.
I went and saw him sitting in the back of the hall yesterday with UC Pinamaki. They were looking at the data and stuff. And Steve was like, you know what? We're having fun. We're supposed to be here. We're racing cars. I was like, how you doing? He's like, I'm at a racetrack. I'm racing cars. I'm having fun. Everything's good. Yeah. I'm also, as you say, a brand new dad, which he's so excited about, which of course everybody would be. And so congratulations to Steve and Jen. You know, Jen, look forward to seeing you back at the track soon. We're one of them little pairs of baby cans, you know, to keep those ears safe from these noisy rallycross cars.
So right now we're moving on to Scott Speed, who is our number two qualifier. He will get a bye run, so he'll complete his three laps. Earlier we saw Timmy Hansen. He qualified number one, but he didn't go at it. He just kind of crawled through the track, you know, just on a Friday afternoon cruise here. But Scott Speed, as Scott Speed is going through the course, again, we are going to take a look. I mean, all the drivers – they got to be excited. And Travis said, man, it's anybody's game, right? Anybody can get the win. But let's look some more into maybe their love loss or their affinity for other drivers.
There's an endless list of names that I'm excited to race against.
For 2021, I'm just excited, you know, racing with my little brother, Oliver.
Obviously, racing Travis Pastrana, I've never done that before. That'll be cool.
I think Travis is gonna do extremely well. He's, you know, we have a lot of jumps now, and Travis is really great at that.
I'm very excited to race against the RX Cartel. I've heard a lot about them.
We have been the team that people wants to beat, so I think that's good.
For me personally, I'm excited to race against myself. You know, to me, it's always been a battle within.
I'm very excited to go race against both the Hansen team, right? Kevin and hopefully Timmy.
I want really to defend my title in all these five events that we have, and I'm just so eager to get going.
All right, as Scott Speed continues on through the course, seeing friends from all across the globe watching and tuning in. Gotta love this. We are locally here in North America on Peacock by NBC. And then, of course, we got to, again, around the world on YouTube. So thank you so much. I'm Jared Deenda. Andrew Coley and I are calling the action, and our other co-hosts, Kate Osborne, down in the pits and wrapping up with the drivers. And our dude that's having fun out there, Todd Richards. He's having a blast. Again, whoever, you know, owns the Audis, I know there's three of them out there, keep an eye on Todd Richards. Keep an eye. He might be stealing the car. It might escape. It's going home with Todd Richards. Can't fit in his bag, but he might very well just drive it home back to San Diego.
Yeah, it's great to have Todd with us on the team again, isn't it? Todd was the desk host for Nitro World Games the last two times we were here in 18 and 19. He's an Audi driver himself and a big Rallycross fan. So, yeah, pleasure to have him back. And Kate as well, of course, got a big history in Rallycross, GRC. She worked on World RX as well.
Yep.
Yeah, we're getting the crew back together for Nitro Rallycross.
Todd the Stingray Richards. That's how he gained his nickname. Old steak feet. He's cooking his feet.
You're gonna need to go deep into Todd's Instagram to have the faintest idea what we're on about. But so Stingrays and Todd, they just don't get along, do they? Six times, is it, Jared? Six times. Six times.
Barbed foot Todd Richards. Woo. All right, so there is the checkered flag from our boy Patrick. Checkered flag with a Q, joining us out here. Again, getting the band back together. And there is Scott Speed, who has just a relationship with this course. Not the prettiest, but still exciting. And he wants to get out here. He has something to prove. Let's take a look as the bracket is shaping up a little bit further. Scott Speed, so we are more than halfway completed with our 16. Scott Speed will be going against either Rude Dude, Bad Rude, Attitude, Master Blue, Snackarude, Andreas Backarude, going against Kevin Hansen up next. When we come back, we'll be seeing Andreas Backarude and Kevin Hansen going against each other here at Utah Motorsports Campus, brought to us by the Utah Sports Commission. Nitro Rallycross continues.
And we are back at Utah Motorsports Campus for the battles that are just now starting to heat up, like the temperature is out here as well. If you take a look at the starting lineup right there, you have Andreas Backarude in a longer Subaru and Kevin Hansen, who his car looks a little bit shorter. And talking with Andreas, he said that is a lacier but more forgiving car, and he actually prefers a longer one. It can be an advantage on this track, as that dirt is always changing. We'll see if that's an advantage for him out there against Kevin Hansen. Guys.
Thank you so much, Katie. 30 seconds here, and we're going to get some words with Liam Doran. He's joining us up here.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Liam.
How are you doing?
It's unfortunate you have to join us, but happy to see your face.
I'll be honest, I'd rather not be in here, but I'm here all the same. So,
what do you think of this bracket battle format, man? Here we are.
It's great. It's really, really cool. It's action, only I'm not in it. So,
I sensed maximum sarcasm mode there for a minute. You know, what do you think of it? I hate it. I'm not
still got my race suit on for no reason whatsoever.
It's all good.
I mean,
at the end of the day, you lost one point. It comes down to tomorrow. What do you make of the track?
No, it's really fun. It's a great format of racing. The track's absolutely unbelievable to drive. It's getting complicated now. It's getting real tricky. Because it's slippery, but yeah, it's racing all the time.
Yeah, here we go. Andrew, what do you got?
Backward Hansen. Got the start here from Kevin Hansen. Kevin looks to the inside line, going to get close onto the tailgate of the Subaru. This is advantage backward, but we're going to see two very different cars here. As Katie was saying, long wheelbase for the Subaru. Backward competed in the Focus before, which was pretty long wheelbase. But don't forget, Kevin Hansen, the current champion, 2019 Nitro Rallycross champion here, will not want to lose the battle to Backward. These two are fierce rivals.
Wow, Backward is looking so fast over there on that bank, as Liam was just describing. It's getting loose. You get in that sill. We saw Tanner Fast use all of that bank, going all the way to the top, almost dragging bumper. Now watch this whip. See, overshoots it.
It's super complicated because the blue groove looks like it's the way to go, but you don't know whether to drive carefully and just try and hide the inside line or just send it in backwards, and I don't know what one works yet.
Liam, we're seeing people try a bunch of different stuff. The two places we've seen the most mistakes are the step up into the hairpin, but also the first berm where we saw Lars and your teammate spin earlier.
Yeah.
What's the deal with that first
bank corner? Quite rough as well, so you've got to think about preserving the car. You know, flats aren't going to work for anyone. So you've just got to think about that, and I think preserving the car to get the three laps in, but the clear thing at the moment is you've got to get the start. You have to get the start. You get out in front, you've got a clear track, and which is what Andreas has done.
Yeah, backwards gone Joker. The gap was 5.8. We know this is going to be close at 5.5.
Oh,
the big
close.
Subaru backing in now into the tunnel. Kevin Hansen coming up over the jump. Going to be real close. Kevin's going to get it, though. Backward going to be alongside.
No.
He's going to go high on the back. And Kevin's low. Watch for the exit. Andreas going to come down low. Going to get the advantage here. Kevin's now got the inside line. Backward goes high. Oh, backwards going to come low now into the dust. Out to the inside line. Going to try and get him at the hairpin, but Kevin goes defensive. He might be able to rotate it, Jared.
Man, these guys are going for it. You're pulling on my shirt. God, you're trying to unclothe me here. You get too excited, Andrew. Calm down.
You need to get used to this.
Exactly. I love it. But you talk about the rivalry. Look how dusty the cars are. Now vision becomes, you know, difficult, right?
Now it's really, really tough for Andreas. It's really tough to follow now in this dusty car. But Kevin's just done a great job to get back from behind. Way, way good job.
You wish he has tear-offs right now on this windscreen, right? But no, he does not. So Kevin Hansen has the clean air. Backward, he's getting very dusty. Both of them have hit the Joker lap, the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. And look at that. Oh,
yeah,
Andreas with a wide swing there.
The thing is as well there, because of the way the dust is coming, look at the way it goes, Jared, from that inside line all the time. Back on the outside, there's dirty and dusty. And Backward's actually dropping back. He's gone into the Joker again.
Intended to go to the Joker.
I think actually what happened there is he couldn't see where he was going.
Do you think so?
Honest. I think he hit straight into the tyre bundle with no idea where he was.
The only thing, I wondered if he had an issue, obviously he wouldn't go for the gap with an issue, Liam, but the car seems okay, doesn't it?
It does. I think it's like, I'm telling you, it's so hard to drive in these conditions. Practice this morning was an absolute piece of cake now driving this. It's like, you have no clue as a driver whether it's better to go faster, slower, inside, outside, like, it's a proper gamble.
Are you gathering a bunch of data, though, for tomorrow? Like,
oh, yeah, yeah.
This is gonna be a similar
I'm really
time.
Enjoying watching getting on the game. Like, it's so good.
you want to be out there feeling it.
Yeah,
so
there's only one way.
It's really bumpy as well, is what you're saying. So even that blue groove, you can see it looks like the surface.
Yeah, I don't know what turn it is, but after the jump, the bank turn after the jump, super bumpy. And it's really tough because you could go super high, but then you get into the fluff, which could put you into the K-rail, or you go low, but it's really bumpy. If you go sideways through the bumps, you're going to DB the tyre. So, like, I genuinely have not figured out a way around the corner. It probably looked that way as well.
And this is how it got done here. We see that of Andreas Backerud take that Yokohama Tire Joker lap. And just let it be known, Kevin Hansen does get the win. This is exciting. This is an exchange. This is a boxing match.
This is what we want. This is what's great about the bank turns as well, is the fact it gives you the option line. So look, Backward goes high, then he goes low. Backwards entry to the Joker. He backed it in a little bit early and then had to pull the car out from the apex slightly. I wonder with that if he might have been able to shut the door, but your exit speed's so low, Jared, you're looking for grip and trying to find a way through. This side-by-side stuff here was just epic. Look at this. Kevin runs up into the dirt, backwards up the inside, it goes back the other way. Larson jumped this inside line. There's another 3 feet of track width there, which people aren't using. Only Robbins used it so far.
As we take a look, so that step up there, Liam.
Look at Kevin here, like, block him.
Yep.
Kevin braked on the takeoff just to hold him behind him.
He cased
literally,
it, didn't he?
Cased it deliberately, just so there was no chance. Just caught him out.
He got fat.
Time.
He got big. He got real
that
fat.
Was,
got
it's smart. I mean, what can you say? It's smart. I'm going to have to put it out there and say that Andreas' strategy there was really bad. There's no way he should have joked with on the second lap.
You think so? Go on, tell us. Go on, talk us through.
He's leading the race. The track's yours. The track's clear. There's no dust.
all you've got to do is put your back wheel in a little bit of fluff, create some dust, and the guy's going backwards behind you. So the fact that he didn't take another lap and create some more dust.
So that's what you
would
do. So what you
100%.
Would,
it was my plan from the start.
But what, to make the track dirty for the guy behind you? So you'd literally run offline on purpose
into the lead. Destroy the track, no one's going past you. But he joked and let him pass him. So sorry, Bert, I'm going to have to tell that was bad.
Sorry, Bert. Oh, man, you love that. I mean, that's what drivers, I mean, they're looking at technique, their strategy, and it's only three laps. It's kind of all thrill or no filler, and hitting that joker lap is it's critical. You know, either do it the first or the second or the third. Kevin Bigham, and here's your Jamaican boy, McConnell.
Yeah, McConnell with a great start on the inside line. Bigham had that car loaded up hard. The Audi, though, loses out, gets out, dragged down to turn one. Bigham goes wide, going to cut back to the inside line. Oh, McConnell just shuts the door. Look how dusty the tarmac is there. McConnell rotates the car around now. Okay, this is where we've seen everybody who's lost the start, everybody has gone joker. Cabot Bigham goes straight away.
So again, either first or third, Liam, that's what you're saying?
Yeah, if to be honest, I'll give you my strategy now if it's over. I was going to joker for the lead.
Joker
because
for the lead.
It worked for me 10 years ago at X Games, and take the guy in with you for sure. I was going to the Joker and Travis would have followed me for sure, but the plan didn't work out.
That would have been cool. I'm kind of gutted. We haven't seen it now. That's just... Oh, Fraser just runs the front wheels across the top of the
at this
but
point
tidy.
Now on the track, though, see, earlier on in the event, we were clearing the jump, no problem. You now can't stop. You just simply can't stop for that corner. So you're better off casing the jump just to scrub the speed off so you can get around the corner. Because if you clear the land and grease it, you're going off the next one.
But you have the potentiality of breaking suspension.
Yeah, well... It's a balance. This track, honestly, at the moment, is one big compromise. Yeah.
5.9 was the gap. It's 6.1 now to Bigham. 6.0 at the last check. Let's see when Bigham comes over the line now. And then McConnell's got to either do what most people have done, 6.6.
Wow.
So McConnell's killing this. So he could easily stay out, Liam. He could afford to stay out. He's
Fraser's been fast all day, though. You know, Fraser's been fast all day. But I think it's the right strategy. Why go in? You know, you've got a faster lap time. Create some more dust out in front, have a clear track the whole race. So that's the right strategy.
I don't think you'll have raced Fraser so far, will
never.
You?
But no,
I guess
you have.
Kind of.
He's been doing some great driving.
I was going to say, you've been across ARX and when he did Nordic as well. Yeah.
Seen a lot of him. He's had some great races. He's new boy to let's say to the
he's
crowd.
A, he's good lad.
He's doing a great job.
He's a good lad.
He's the greenhorn, so you've already shamed him, right? You've already hazed him.
Look how tidy he was in here again. To be fair, Bigham was also tidy on his run. So again, look, get it slowed down, get it rotated.
You can hear the car almost all in. Almost all in. So there is just that little grip now. Everyone's on the same track, though, so everyone's got the same problem.
So Fraser McConnell now, he has to go for that joker lap. Look at that, 8.74. That was that last clip right there at the end. But Kevin Bigham, what do you got?
His rear window's open, so the rear quarter windows can be taken out so you can access the top of the rear dampers easily. And if you watch Francis' rear quarter window, it's open. So that car is going to be absolutely full of dust. And breathing it in, it can be really hard work.
9 second gap between McConnell and Bigham, and he's definitely going to take the lead, but now he's got to keep it clean. As Liam is just describing here, what's going on track, it gets loose as you go up in the silt, kind of pace, just keep it slow, keep it mellow. And I mean, Kevin Bigham, he hasn't had a ton of practice out here on the course, and this course is just completely modifying. We're talking about the different variables, vehicles, of course, but it's just transforming throughout the day and the weekend.
The window's gone completely for Fraser.
I don't know if this is going to be helping him up. He's probably going to be drawing the dust back out.
That's true. He's going to take the win here, but it's not a win for his mechanics because they're going to get that Hoover out, and they're going to be really busy in the back of that car for right until his next bracket.
You can actually see inside; it's full of dust.
Yeah, the inside of the screen. So it's a great win for McConnell, really confident one. Got in front of Bigham and then just extended that gap. Cabot Bigham crosses the line. Bigham's out for today, but Fraser McConnell's going through to the next one.
This is a little bit of a world colliding, huh, Liam? Like, it just with the brackets for me, you know, announcing drifting, this is kind of a melding,
yeah,
right?
100%, yeah. As soon as I saw the format come out, the first thing I thought was Formula Drift, you know? Right. And I didn't want to be sitting out your top eight, great eight, all that stuff. I was looking forward to it, if I'm honest. But I think it's a great format. It's 100% a great format, and it's giving good action.
Talk us through what you're seeing from Fraser here.
Well, Fraser's had good times all day. You know, he was fast this morning when the track was tacky. He's been fast even when it's greased up now, and it's super, super slippery. But he's adapted to it really well. I'm jealous, if I'm honest, because I definitely have not done that. So fair play to him for adapting. He's got good times. I think he will go quite far through his battle now.
All right, well, as Fraser McConnell advances on, let's throw it down to Stingray. Todd Richards, Sting.
Yeah, wow, Stingray. Hey, guys, the real stars here of this, you know, you got your Travis Pastranas or whatever, but it's really the supercars. Now, these things, 600 horsepower, 680 foot-pounds of torque, 0 to 60 in under 2 seconds. That's faster than an Aventador. That's faster than a Veyron. And in spite of what your friend Mike says, who lives next door, who just got the new Snap, Crackle, and Pop tune on his Mustang, well, it's faster than that, too.
the Rice Krispie treat, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Michael's a great guy. I don't know why Todd's got something against him in his Ford Mustang Snap, Crackle, Pop. You know, do you have Rice Krispie treats?
Yeah, we do. Yeah. We do. Okay. Yeah, we have Rice Krispie treats. Sure.
I've actually got a Snap, Crackle, and Pop map on my car as well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and you're out of your wagon, right? You have your wagon at home. Of course you do.
I do, yeah. Liam, you've got to have Snap, Crackle, and Pop.
Liam, tell us about the RS6, Liam.
You've caught me off guard here. Yeah. Actually, my car, I think, is faster than these cars. Okay. Sorry, Todd. Sorry, yeah. Like my street car is actually faster.
Liam, do you remember the first time we met?
Mike next door has got an Audi R6. It's faster. And he's got Snap, Crackle, and Pop, too.
Do you remember the first time we met, Liam?
I do remember the first time
This guy.
It was a while.
I was like, who is it? But like, hey, man, I saw you won the next games. You really seem like a jerk because the quote was when he won X Games.
Yep.
It was so easy.
There's been a massive. It really bit me that did, man. Really
it
hard.
Did?
It did because everyone thought I was being genuine, but no one realized it because where the area I'm from in Southeast England, it was like, well, what can you say? But then everyone was like, he's legit a jerk. Like, that was not cool.
And you came in wearing a cowboy hat and cowboy boots, so you're the first British cowboy I've ever met.
That's it.
This guy. But ten years later.
I think Ken genuinely came to me afterwards and was like, Ken Block was like, I mean, I don't know, that wasn't necessary, was it? Easy. I was like, I didn't mean it. It was a joke. He was like, yeah, sure.
Did it come across? That flew like an
I'm
anvil.
Actually not that bad. I play it up, to be honest. So. Anyway, my Audi's pretty fast.
Yeah, it is. He's got a tire shredding Audi, which he has shredded some tires in it, definitely. Kevin Erickson versus Oliver Bennett. Bennett in the Mini. The Mini turned up here a little bit late, and so he was on the back foot in terms of getting it prepped. Straight over the gap jump. Ollie Bennett, to be fair, said it was like his motocross days. Green light for those two. And Ollie Bennett's got a brilliant start. Put the squeeze on Kevin Erickson on the run to turn one. Going to shut the door. Liam, you had a little bit of a hand in the Mini.
That was a great job by Bennett to be getting the lead from the outside there. Yeah, it's a great car.
Peepo engine, isn't it?
Engineered by myself, that car is. So
yes,
here he goes again.
The humility is just stacking on.
No, I'm just joking.
No, you're not.
Well, no, you're not. What a jerk. Who invited him into the commentary box?
I think it was one of you guys.
He's the most humble guy he knows.
If you're wondering how Liam got it, by the way, I text Liam and he didn't reply, so I text Andrea and he was here
his wife.
Minutes later.
Yeah.
So
you know how it works.
Bennett, all joking aside, Bennett takes kind of an awkward line here. This is that momentum. Let's see.
Nah, too late on the race.
Not ideal.
Wide.
Ollie's taking a different line there in the head, but he's the first guy we've seen go on. And Kevin's got an even better line. That was cool.
He threw his keys at the valet and said, park it up front.
Kevin might have actually fully over-rotated that. Ollie's making too many mistakes here. But I think Kevin's had a big half spin in the background. He's not over the tabletop jump at the back. He's a long way back. So Bennett spotters need to see this now. Yeah.
Joker, look at the gap. Go, go, go. Got to be done, boys. Getting Joker now?
Yeah, 100%. Definitely.
100%.
No, and he's made another mistake.
Ollie, what is happening?
Oh, he's broken the car.
And Liam, Liam, do you want to talk about engineering now?
No Joker. That whoever engineered that car needs to go home.
He's got to go. He's not going
to
go.
No Joker. And look, the gap closes. It was up to 10.2 seconds. As Ollie definitely needs a game.
But now Kevin's stopped to the back.
Now it's
going to be really interesting.
Let's take a breath. So basically, Bennett there, I thought he broke on the car, he ran so wide. But Bennett has run wide, in all the corners, to be fair to Ollie. I think he's still going to win.
I think he bumped. I think he just bumped the car down.
Down at the end.
The car's not rotating. Yeah. That's the problem. I mean, both when he came in on turn one or into turn two, and then the car's just not rotating, I think, how he wanted to.
He's been going well, though. Like, he's done some decent times. I think he was about halfway up the session earlier
on. He is struggling with the car turned in, I think. You can actually find yourself putting too much rear grip into the chassis, and then you can't rotate the car. It's great to get out the corner, but you can't get into it either. So I'd say at the moment he's got a lot of rear grip around
the chassis. So running really soft on the back to try
rear
and find grip.
Maybe even rear roller off. Rear roller off would give you a lot of rear grip. You'd lose front. You wouldn't be able to get the car to turn in, but you'd get out the corners. But it might work, you know. He's using a handbrake. The track is so awkward to attack the track. You can't. So he might have just taken the decision. Listen, I'll find my way into the corner, but I can get out of it at least. Because he is actually getting out of the corner. It's pretty good.
All right, so Ollie Bennett does take that Joker lap, and you can see 27 seconds between him and Kevin Erickson. Erickson nowhere part of the picture. He's in a different chapter altogether. But Ollie Bennett, as long as he keeps it tidy, he's going
to
have the picture.
They're on the radio to Ollie. You can see he's backed it off now. When he ran deep in this corner, I was like, this is game over. You know, Kevin.
Backed it off and gone a bit faster, actually. What, I'm honest, backing off looks like he's working better for
it's
him.
It's so slippery.
Yeah,
it's
just so slippery. Just chilling a little bit. Maybe not this chill. But chilling a little bit gives you a little bit of a tactic.
So while we wait for Kevin to come round, Liam, what's the score? And looking at the track conditions, knowing tomorrow is probably going to start quite quickly and get a bit loose as the day goes on, are you going to go and dial the car in a bit?
I was going to come up here and ask you what you thought, because I have no plan whatsoever.
Well, you're here now, mate. So
yeah,
you know,
no, I mean, this morning was absolutely, literally, this morning driving this track was the best thing I've ever done in a rally.
Wow.
It was fantastic.
What?
Like, it's the most fun I've ever had.
That's a testimonial right there. And you guys really talked us up, Liam. Getting that launch from the outside, closing the door, as you said,
strong,
Andrew.
That's absolutely strong.
But the Pipo engine, it's a very well-known engine. Solberg used it in his build back in the day, and everyone was like, wow, what is this? And it's just such a strong start as well. It's
good,
brilliant,
reliable,
isn't it?
Platform.
This was where we thought he'd made a mistake, but look at Kevin, and just that's what I mean. He went all the way round, and I think he thought he was going to style it out, and then in fact he's had to go back and give it the figure of eight, cut the corner and rejoin in, and that was 7-8 seconds.
Yeah.
And then Bennett runs wide at the end of the straight. Here's Bennett at the end of the straight. Look, we know it's dusty down there, but watch this. On the brakes and just fully out to the outside. I thought it was broken.
That car really doesn't want to turn in, does it?
No.
It's not wanting to turn in.
So you're going to go and have a word, as you're such a legendary engineer. You're going to go and just fix it for him straight away.
Don't listen to anyone who has anything to do with that.
All things considered, you could drive that car. Your suit matches the car.
It
the whole
does
livery.
Match
it's
the car.
Totes adorbs.
It does.
You guys are adorable.
I hadn't noticed that.
Thank you, Liam, for joining us, man. We're going to take a break. We're going to do some course maintenance. So grab a broom. Liam, get out there. You lost.
Best thing I could do right now is get out there and do some track work, right?
Exactly. Yes, the British bomb. Hey, guess what? You're still
humble.
Competing tomorrow.
Still humble.
Still the most humble guy.
Stay humble. What a cool guy.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you to Liam Doran. And again, Andrew, great day, man. This is great. We made history here. Our first ever bracket battles. And we have our great eight shaped up. And that's how it lays out there, Andrew.
Yeah, brilliant first few rounds. We're on to the quarterfinals now, heading towards the semis and the final. Big thanks to Liam Doran for coming up and giving us a bit of fun up here in the booth. So, yeah, good fun. Stay with us. We've got some more racing to come, and it's getting serious now. On to the quick guys. Bit of track maintenance going on here at Utah Motorsports Campus for Nitro Rallycross, taking a look around cars down in the pre-grid, getting themselves ready to continue the battles. Ollie Bennett with the front end of the Mini up. He had a few issues. The team working on that, getting himself ready. We've got ourselves eight cars going through to the quarterfinals, semis and final to come after that as well. That's the view of the beautiful mountains in the background here at Utah. Water being fired out the back of the trucks. That's just to damp things down a little bit. We've got the Bobcats out there as well. They're just like the little excavators, which have got sweepers and buckets on them. They worked so hard last night to get this track into great condition for this morning's action and this afternoon. And I have to say, it's been absolutely brilliant so far. My name's Andrew Coley. Jared Deander on commentary with me here as well. We've got Katie Osborne down in the paddock, talking to the drivers, bringing us some updates on what's going on. And Todd Richards is with us as well. Lorette Nickel on some of the social coverage as well. That's the 199 car of Travis Pastrana. We had a ride with Travis Pastrana in the 199 car. So here you go. Here's an onboard of this incredible track, the birthplace of Nitro Rallycross.
The start, 0-60 in under 2 seconds. Going into the biggest change from last year, we have an inside line or an outside line. Hopefully this is going to make the field a lot more spread out, a lot less carnage, but there is a hairpin at the end of that long outside left lane. Both lanes, inside and outside, are within a tenth of a second. Really good chicane right through here, coming up to the best roller coaster you'll ever see, 130 feet to the sweet spot. All the lanes come back together, merging into the Talladega right. You can cut that a little bit tight and then go over the bump to the inside. Super fun, feels like a awesome roller coaster ride all the way around into a big old jump right here. You have the option to kind of stay and hug that tire or use a little bit of the berm on the outside. This is a big difference from last year. We're staying on the pavement, keeping a little bit more speed. should make for some great passing in this left-hand corner. There's a berm on the outside, or you can hug the inside. Both are equally as quick. Coming down, it gets really narrow, going right across this finish line, and that is a lap of Nitro Rallycross round one.
Great look at the track. We're going to head down and have a catch up with Katie Osborne, who's with Timmy Hansen, and get Timmy's thoughts on how conditions are down there now as we head into the quarterfinals of the battles. Timmy is going to be up against Travis Pastrana.
Right, he is. And actually, right before he got in the car to go over to the actual start line, he said it's still extremely dusty out there. Now, remember, he had a little R&R there this last time around. He hasn't had that flow like Travis had. He told me that what the big key here is not to make the mistakes and capitalize on the others. He also said that one thing to keep an eye on is when others go around that joker lap, to not make the mistake on the real track, because he said you think you have an advantage there and you over push it, but that's where you can get into trouble. So that is his focus as he's going up against Travis.
Thank you so much, Katie, as we're taking some selfies up here, so no big deal.
what a jerk.
we're hashtag Red Bull. hashtag Red Bull team right here. Look at this. These two bulls are going at it. See who's going to take out each other here, man. Timmy Hansen, Travis Pastrana. This should be a barn burner.
So Pastrana, when Kevin won last year, he was like, that's it, I'm banning the Swedes, because Timmy had won the first year. Kevin won the second. He's like, that's it, they're not coming anymore. Okay, about half the field is still Swedish, so yep. Travis obviously decided, that's cool, right, we need them. But this is a good one, you know. Come on, Travis. Get it done.
Meatballs. We're talking about Volvos. We're talking about IKEA. That's what Hansen. That's what Switzerland makes. And the Hansen Bros. That's what
Sweden.
You put your bum on the Swedish. The Swedish. That's a deep Tom Green quote right there. For whatever reason, I pulled that out of my bag of tricks. But look at the set. Look at the stage here. Beautiful day. And this is the forecast for this weekend. This is how it's going to look. Timmy Hansen, Travis Pastrana. You see the Yokohama Tire girl. The 32nd card is up. And she exits stage left, 10 seconds till full pull on our first battle in this great eight. So round two, heat one, Timmy Hansen, TP Travis Pastrana.
Hansen's on a great run of form this year. He's competing in the World Rallycross Championship, but also in Extreme E, the Electric Off-Road Series.
Busy man.
He just seems to be on the podium, on the top step quite a lot of the time. Good start for Pastrana on the outside, but Hansen's going to out drag him down the inside line. Oh, Travis having none of it, going to try and go all the way around the outside in the big Subaru. He's going to get on the bars, going for the sideways drift. Now he's going to straighten up to the inside line, but Timmy's there just in front of me. Tidily done by Travis.
Well done. Not knocking on Heaven's door, but knocking on Hansen's door. They both go for the jump, and here we go. Send it full pull to the moon. Not talking Dogecoin. Travis going wide. Let's see how he handles this bank. Woo-wee!
He's going for the wide line, going to try and get inside of Hansen. He does. Contact between them, going to cut the inside line. Brilliant move from Pastrana. Timmy gets back on the inside line again, over the jump now, coming up to the braking zone. Travis going to get on the bar. He'll look for the inside line here. He's got it done. Timmy runs wide. Pastrana with some brilliant racecraft here. Man. Timmy's got the inside for the tarmac.
Look at this mosh pit of a battle here between Hansen and Pastrana. This is just an appetizer, man. This is a blooming onion. Oh, look at that. Hansen cut the corner.
Hansen's back on it. He's hit three or four passes on this lap. This is absolutely brilliant racing from these two. Pastrana, Hansen, he's in this incredible run of form. Pastrana's taking it to him. Pastrana's the first person not to joker when he lost the start. He's going, no, I'm going with you. Let's fight.
Yep, anything you can do, I can do better. As he shadows him around, who's going to take the joker or not? Neither of them take the joker. So here we go. This is like lap two, and both of them airing it out. Really like Pastrana's line on that berm and in the bank. Now Hansen looks like he hits clean air. Look at that rut. That massive rut.
Travis can do both. We saw him go high and wide on the last run. Now he's gone tight and low. I mean, Travis, don't forget, ARA Rally Champion this year with Rhiannon Gelsomino.
Oh.
Brilliant job. Hansen runs a bit deep, but Travis keeps it tidy. The only thing I would say is by not joking on lap two, he didn't give himself any option. He has to now pass on track, and that's tough. But we want to see great racing, and Travis, you always know, don't you, Scott? What's the best show? Sonic, I'll go with him.
Oh, look at TV. Going over a little sideways, a little nasty. White flag is out. So here's the scenario. Both of them have completed two laps. This is the final lap. The Joker lap needs to get hit by both the drivers. Take that Yokohama Joker lap. This is going to get exciting. Who's coming out first? Let's see what we got.
Travis closed Timmy down there, but Timmy was pretty sideways in that corner. Look at the way he's got the Subaru rotating again on the way in. He's going to be in the dust cloud now. It's tricky. So
This is the first time we've seen it from the drone like this. It's actually downhill, meaning it's hard to spot where the inside line is.
Oh!
Hansen Travis. Into the wall! Did Travis push him off?
Let's roll the tape back, my friends. They come out of that Yokohama Joker lap, and we see Timmy get punted out of the way.
So as Stuart said to us yesterday, if it's a push, you will definitely get penalized. So. The thing is, Travis could have been in the dust there and genuinely not seen how quick behind
all
he was.
All right. We see whose team you're on. Yeah. I'm joking.
Or we could have seen a mistake from Timmy. Did Timmy get too sideways? We'll take a look back in a minute, I'm sure.
Yeah, for sure. They're going to roll the tape back on that one. I'm not seeing much front damage, so that basically is an indication that, you know, maybe Timmy just spun out, maybe got a little out of shape. But regardless, checkered flag waves for Travis Pastrana. Timmy Hansen still stranded back there outside of that Yokohama Tire Joker lap.
I agree with you that there isn't the damage on the front there. I'm looking at the
back,
the back of Timmy's car shows maybe contact. So
under investigation. Dunk dunk. like insert Law and Order theme song. Dunk dunk. Right? Executive producer Dick Wolf. Executive producer Todd Richards, the Stingray.
Right, maybe we'll see it. Look at this. First of all, look at this for a battle. This is all, remember, we're calling this battle. This is the battle section of qualifying.
He's saying battle, everybody. Battle.
It's a battle. Whatever. It was just great racing. Watch Pastrana here. The car's up with a load of action. He goes deep on the brakes and goes high into the loose. You're like, that won't work. But he lights it up, and he's alongside Timmy on the exit. Timmy tries to run the Peugeot high, shut the door. Pastrana's got him. Now Timmy then goes inside. This is probably my favorite section of the track, Jarrod, because of the fact it's high, low, high, low. Yeah. Whenever the corners go in opposite directions, you get that double chance. Look at this. Timmy goes defensive. Travis is like, I know what you're doing. I'm on the bar. Inside, gets in the door. He's got it done again.
Yeah, and we saw that with the other Hansen, Backerud and Kevin Hansen. And look at him cut the corner there.
Brilliant. So Timmy's then done exactly what Travis did to him earlier. He's gone, yeah, you're going to go deep in there. I'll stick it straight back up the inside of you. So here we go. This is what happened. They're coming out of the Yokohama Joker lap. We might have this from the drone, which could give us a clue. Is Travis clever enough to have done it in the tunnel? I mean, where no one can see. Oh, dear. Nothing to see here.
What color are those hands? those look red.
Those are dead.
Those look red there, Travis.
Travis Pastrana.
Oh, yeah, that would have been really... I didn't do anything in the tunnel. Like, you know,
it wasn't me. Here we go. Half a second earlier and he'd have got away with it. You pesky kids.
Yeah.
He's been caught, hasn't he?
That, you know, the tunnel of love turned into a tunnel of hate down there in the Yokohama Tire Joker lap.
Why was it
like? Travis, is that a smirk? Is that a smile? What's up there?
I hope Katie's down there. I really, go and get him. Come on, let's see
what he's getting. Katie, get over there. Talk to Travis.
Okay, we're hearing. Okay, right. So we're hearing Hansen had a mechanical, and so okay, that would be excusable if Hansen had a mechanical, then Travis hit him, but it's under investigation. So so let's see.
We haven't seen. Did we see the final verdict? Have we gotten the official?
I'm looking across at Krista in race control now.
Keep in mind the winner goes to the final four. Katie, talk to him.
Yeah, no, you guys, I wish you guys were down here because he's actually smiling and said, this was awesome. Your takeaway from that, I mean, was that rubbing his racing?
We were definitely really aggressive with Timmy. Timmy's the best in the world. You know, definitely the American. Scott's trying to take that title from him over here with NRX. But, felt really good. And once he got around, like, I knew on the jump, I didn't even hit the button. I just went till I was almost caught up to him and then slammed the brakes on the takeoff. So the car's flying all sideways, but... We were able to make almost a pass around the outside there. Super slick, so it's hard to get bowed up, really. And Timmy somehow passed me two times super clean. So sorry, Timmy, you are absolutely amazing. And then he was pulling away, and I don't know what happened if he ended up having a tire go down or something. But so no doubt he's a better driver. But when something had happened mechanically, I actually didn't like just punt him off the track. And that one, he was just almost stopped. So there was some reason he wasn't turning. So. Sorry.
We got that side of the story. Let's get to the start line for another one.
All right, so let's go on to this next battle. We'll get back to that that scenario between that of Hansen and Pastrana. Pastrana looks like he does advance on, but right now, who's advancing on to go against him? Tanner Faust or Steve Arpin? Look at that nice pass to the inside. Like he said, Arpin's been driving so well.
I thought Arpin was going to have him there. He's going to go Joker instead. So he's gone alongside him. This is what we're seeing. It's the old thing, because it's so slippery and people are going in a little bit deep, it lets you get alongside. And they go high, you go low. You go high, they go low. That's where the bank turns are so good. And we've seen other rallycross tracks now go with the bank corners. Okay, we're hearing no penalty from race control. Travis Pastrana wins. Was it maybe a puncture for Timmy? We think puncture for Timmy. So I think
that front left. You just check your phone. That front left looked like he had a de-beating. Let's call it a de-beating there. And then that caused him to slow down. And we'll get back to that in a moment. Let's talk about how Faust and Arpin are doing. 4.5 seconds. We talk about that Yokohama tire Joker lap being about 5 seconds. Arpin could be setting himself up for success as he's gaining ground on the golden child, Tanner Faust.
See what the gap is as they come over the line this time. 4.2. He's close enough. So
with Tanner going in, there's no way he's going Yokohama tires over lap.
This is the flip side of the tactics. So you're out front and you think you're getting away, you can stay out if you want. If you think they're gaining on you, you can close. If you've already got too small a gap, you can't joker because he knows he'll lose out to Arpin. So now he has to stay out, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's trying to pull away. His spotter's in his head saying 4.2. You know, he's closing it. It was, you know, up to 5 seconds, but 4.4. So it's going to be really close. And again, a couple more turns here with this lap. And Arpin, I'm telling you, he's performing surgery.
He is. Arpin's been a weapon here. I'll bet you, Pinamac, he's on the radio going, tidy. You're going to close him down. Faust took 2/10 off him in the last sector. Let's see what he's going to cross the start finish line this time round. He's gone up again, so Faust has taken another 10, so he's Arpin been a little bit too tidy.
I think it's smart. I think he's playing a good role here, and now he's going to really get that car to rotate tight into that first turn.
It's another 10th. So Faust is doing a good job. He's taking another 10th, but I don't think 4.6 is going to be enough. Tanner Faust going to go Joker now. In the background, here comes Arpin, watching out for the merge after the big jump.
Here we go. Arpin, he's going to air it out. You can see underneath that Yokohama tire, Joker lap. Here comes Arpin. They should be door-to-door, and no. Arpin gets the jump on him. Now he's going to take that tighter, cleaner line, and then look at Tanner Faust starts at the top and then works his way down. We can see another pass.
Arpin, that
came in like
aggressive.
A wrecking ball. Call him Miley Cyrus. Look at this thing.
That was aggressive, but it was good. Arpin's going to go inside here, and Arpin's going back again. So Arpin gets Faust back. Faust runs deep, drops the car out in the loose stuff. There you go.
Love it.
Yeah,
love it.
Faust's pass was pretty, it was hard. I think it was fair. In rallycross terms, it was a fair pass, but this is a great win for Steve Arpin. He's going to get it done over the tabletop, down off the start finish straight now. Yeah.
Look at Arpin's team cheering him on like Tuscan Raiders from the side over here. And the sand people, you can see the Hemp Fusion vehicle and Yokohama tires gets the win. There you go, Steve Arpin. Gets the win.
I can actually do a pretty good impression of a
Tuscan Raider.
Yes, I can. But
go ahead.
Not right now. Maybe later. Oh, it's under investigation. But if anything's under investigation there, I think it will be the Faust move up the
100%.
Inside. So really, it doesn't make any odds.
No.
Unless there's something we haven't seen.
Arpin had it coming. I'm just kidding. Hey, great race here, though. This just goes to show you alternating positions, Arpin. Just really, again, performing surgery on this track. I believe this, so coming off of this bank into this turn, did Arpin turn in?
Yeah, I think, Faust.
That angle didn't really help the effort here.
Faust is a fair way up the inside. It was aggressive, but that's what we want to see. I don't want to see nobody trying to pass. I didn't think Faust was close enough, to be honest, but he found great traction off the top of that berm. It does look like 4.6 is just about enough, Jared. So, you know, anywhere around the 5-second mark is good. But look at this. Faust comes in hot. He gets on the bar early. And Arpin, you said, surgery. He's been a doctor, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Those last couple of laps, super tidy. And on the last lap, it's just a case of keeping tidy. He didn't even have to really try.
The Canadian Cowboy, 00. Really well done. He is one to watch here. And again, our final will have how many vehicles?
10 cars, 6 laps.
So imagine, we got two.
I can't
ten
wait.
10 is going down tomorrow.
Okay, make sure you're tuning in tomorrow. Yeah, we're going to have a couple of heat races with 7 cars each. Then we're going to go semis with 5 cars each because 4 will have made it through to the final. Then we've got a last chance qualifier with the six that are left and two more go through. There's only four don't make it. And then a six-lap dash for the big trophy in the first ever championship round of Nitro Rallycross here at Utah Motorsport Campus.
All right, here we go with Kevin Hansen, Scott Speed. Look at the smile of Kevin Hansen. Let's see if he could take it to the top. And Speed, he was, this is the first time he's going head-to-head. This is his first bracket battle because he did that, get that number two qualifying position. So he got a bye run into this. Now he has to earn it, going against Kevin Hansen, who has a great history with this track.
Brilliant start between both cars, and Speed, who's been doing all that start testing for Subaru, absolutely got it done. I spoke to the engineers at Subaru, and they just said that Scott's ability to repeat the exact same thing again and again and again is what they needed with the start testing. So you know he's got the repetitiveness to get the data they needed. And he goes Joker on lap one, so that's what Liam Doran said he was going to do. Joker from the lead, you remember? And then he thought Pastrana would go in with him, but Kevin's been clever enough to not go in with him. So you take the lead and you go in. So that hasn't worked. That was, okay, there we go. So Kevin now's going to try and gap him. It's only 3.7 the gap at the moment, so it's not enough.
Let's see how they handle this. Now we're getting starting to see some more turns on this track and really getting loose. And we saw Tanner Faust scrub a lot of speed, and Scott Speed almost coming to a halt there, coming off of that step up. But Kevin Hansen continues on. Let's see what our time here is between
3.9. Hansen gapped him by 0.2, but at the next, not enough. We know that. So we saw earlier on. What was the gap for Arpin? 4.6, I think, wasn't it, in the end? And it was almost side by side. I think if Arpin had been a bit more wily and gassed it up early in the banking and run high, he could have blocked Faust's move off into the left. Nudge of the tyres for speed in the background. Don't think it's enough to get a penalty. No. 3.7, it's not enough. So at the minute, it's not going to work for Kevin.
Yeah. So Kevin Hansen right now with that 3.719 split, as you just said, Coley. He needs to get some more ground. Scott Speed, he's got him on a hook. Can you reel him in when it comes to that Yokohama Tire Joker lap?
Scott's in that nice position, isn't he? You know what it's like when you want to chase. You see the car ahead. You can see, look, he'll have seen Kevin go a bit wide there. Scott, okay, that was
pretty
tidy.
Good.
Yeah, so, and at the minute, he's taken 0.3 off him.
Oh, man.
So Scott Speed is closing down Kevin Hansen, the 2019 and reigning Nitro Rallycross champion. Scott Speed, who broke his back at that event
and hasn't competed since in
Rallycross. He's been out doing some other stuff, but not Rallycross. And at the minute, he's showing his class here. He closes the gap again.
3.375 seconds. On paper, what we've seen, you can only tell the future by looking at the past. He will come out over the jump and we'll have that lead. Here we go.
Kevin's not tidy on the way into the Joker either. He runs deep on the right hand, and this isn't even going to be close.
No.
Speed is over the top as Kevin goes into the tunnel. Scott Speed comes out in front of Kevin Hansen. This has been a great drive with a unique tactic. Joker from the lead, from the start. Great stuff.
They paid off for Scott Speed at this point. Remember, we saw a lot of drivers lose it right here. We saw, you know, Tanner Faust spin out. Look at that technique from Speed. When Liam Doran was up here, he was talking about casing that lane by the designed to take speed out of the car so the momentum doesn't push you off into the sill, into the curtain where all that dust accumulates. And Scott Speed, he's got one more jump, who again, he has history with this jump. This is where he broke his back.
Not his best friend, although to be fair, it has been somewhat beheaded. Not so bad, but Speed takes it for Subaru. That's Pastrana and Speed going through to the semi-finals now. So two of the factory Subarus are through to those final stages. Kevin Hansen, the champion, is out of the battles.
And you know, to think that we started this day with the Subarus kind of having a lackluster beginning.
They had a shocker.
Yeah, they had a shocker. So here they are. You know, you got on either side of the bracket, Pastrana's in the final four. Arpin is who he's going against. But this is how it started. The Subarus are getting a good launch, and Travis says he doesn't normally get a good start. Even though this is speed, he got the jump.
That Peugeot's got a great start on it as well, Jared. You know, Subaru starts were weak. We said they've been off, they've done the testing, they've done this aero, they've been doing durability testing on engine and transmission, and Scott's been responsible for a lot of that. It's a short hop for him up to Vermont to go testing, and they got it done. But this was the unique thing where I've gone Joker straight away. I wonder if they thought Kevin would get sucked in. Kevin doesn't get sucked in. But great, he was 3.5 back and reeled him in.
And this is how it ended. Scott had that massive, 3.3, right? And that gap was just way too much for Kevin Hansen to make up. And Scott Speed comes out on top. And he got a little safe there coming into that bank and that exit on the big gap. And here we are with our final battle of the Great Eights is Oliver Bennett and Fraser McConnell. Again, talking about Jamaica's own here. Uncle Sal cheering them on
Uncle
here.
Uncle Sal. Yeah. We asked the drivers to name their cars. So Ollie Bennett was like, yeah, it's the XI Energy Mini. I was like, Fraz, what do you want to call the car? He's like, it's the OMSC Yardman Fiesta. I was like, okay, Yardman. He's like, Yardman. I'm like, okay, dude, I'll keep practicing.
Yep.
But you will not find a guy who's prouder of his nation than Fraser McConnell. You know, that he's had the Jamaican flag as the colours on his car for the last three seasons, maybe four, I think. And it's been lovely to watch his progression. He was driving an ARX2. He came in wild, like we saw Kasper Janssen earlier. He's finished that season tidy. And since then, Jared, he's just got better and better. A couple of seasons in Supercar now. He's a real threat.
And the big thing here, let's watch Oliver Bennett. He got a great start. We have Liam Doran up here. He says he developed that car. Was he getting the car to rotate? Let's see how it rotates in this first turn. Fraser McConnell gets the jump. Oliver Bennett right there in tow. Let's see how we go into that first turn around that tire bale. And Fraser McConnell keeps it tight. And there it is. Oliver Bennett not getting that car to rotate.
They had Bennett's car up on jacks just a moment ago before we were getting into the quarterfinals. And I wonder if they were maybe trying to take the roll bar off or do something at the front to make it turn in a little bit more. So they've done some work to that, but Fraz has got him. And based on form, you'd think that Fraz would probably get this done, but we'll see. You know, we've seen lots of problems for people so far.
And take a note, when we go past that bank after the big gap jump, take a look, middle of the road, middle of that bank, the car really gets disrupted. Once it kind of initiates and throws in, it really gets bucked. So I want you to pay attention there, Cole. They get another set of eyes on it. As Oliver Bennett
pulled off.
Bennett's pulled off.
So it's an issue for the Mini. So Fraser McConnell is going to take this. And the XI Racing Mini is in the background. Oh, that's a shame. I'm sorry for Ollie because, you know, he did well to get through to this round. But Fraser now will get the radio call that Ollie is out, and they'll just say, wind it in, you're all good. You're all good. So Fraz is going to go through to the semi-finals against Scott Speed.
Yeah, so McConnell, as long as he continues on, he will finish out. But as Liam was giving a lot of accolades, saying the car's looking good, he's looking strong, and now he hits a joker lap. By design, you know, he doesn't have anybody in his rearview mirror.
So Fraser at the start of this year, Jared, just so everybody's aware, he didn't even know if he was going to have the budget to do the Rally X Nordic Series, which was like his warm-up before he put the car on the boat over from Europe to come here and do Nitro. And now here he is doing Nitro Rallycross. All of those sponsors are local to Jamaica and the Caribbean. It's like a really cool local effort, and I love it. I really do. You'll see a bunch of support for him online. Yeah, it's good fun.
And Fraser McConnell's background, do you know his racing pedigree?
Yeah, he did say he'd done some circuit races as well, but it was the rally driving thing into rallycross. Over the line. Got one more lap to go. Fraz dives on the brakes at the end of the straight. He's still using this as a bit of a test session. Coming up to the long left-hander, rotates it nicely to the inside. Right, Pastrana versus Arpin, Speed versus McConnell. Who's your money on?
I'm going to go Arpin, man. Arpin, just the way he is driving right now. I think Pastrana wants it, of course. But the way Arpin's driving, he's getting that car to rotate. He's hitting all the corners. And with the car, with the track being really slick, because we've seen a few battles here in the Grade 8, I would say that it's getting really loose, and Arpin has been performing really well. Fraser McConnell and Scott Speed, again, this longer wheelbase, you know, these Subarus, getting them to rotate in the dust. I'm kind of leaning towards, you know, we're looking at Fraz right now and the way he's executing it.
I'm liking it. I'm glad you went for it.
This is only bracket battles, okay? There's one point at stake. Yeah. I'm going to call it like I see him. Like I said, you can't tell the future unless you look at the past.
They're both on form.
And guess what? Tomorrow, that's when I'm not going to make any claims. Because the variable is 10 cars, the track, the jump, the Yokohama tire joker. I mean, this is how it started here. Fraser McConnell. What happened to Ollie?
Fraz's exit through those first two corners was really good. He was tidy on both the tire bales on either side. Ollie's looking good at this point as well in the Mini. We didn't really see anything that indicated that he had a big issue. Although there, you see, if he's dipped the rear left in and broken a shaft or broken the rear diff, then he will know that, you know, immediately that he's done. Watch in the background. Is there smoke or dust? It's hard to tell, isn't it? Dust, I'd say.
Yeah, I believe it's dust.
So, yeah.
That front left, there is smoke. I don't know.
Bennett did message me earlier. They'd had an issue. I'll drop him a message now and see if we can find out what.
Slide in those DMs.
Yeah.
You getting up in all his DMs?
No, it's, we're all good.
Keep it creepy there, Coley. Creepy Coley.
He messaged me, so. creepy.
And here's taking a look at the bracket as Fraser McConnell crosses that finish line. And we talked about forging that final four, the Tiger Power Sandals Yardman. The vehicle
the
here.
Yardman Fiesta.
Yep, the Yardman Fiesta.
Forever.
Right, come on. There's a shape up of our Nitro Rallycross. Thank you to the Utah Sports Commission for having us out here. Pastrana versus Arpin, Speed versus McConnell. What did Ollie say?
So they had issues earlier on with the diff release and some bubbles in various bits of stuff. But I've texted him and said, look what happened there, dude. He's probably not got the phone in the car. We'll see.
Well, speaking of messages, what has Katie got?
Well, I'll tell you, one guy who is not doing that any Jamaican festival right now is Tanner Faust. It's a guy who's kind of working through what just happened there. And as a driver, what's your take on how much of that was your fault?
Oh, all of that was my fault. Yeah, no, the racing was good with Arpin. You know, he's super quick. And I think he was over. We were dead even, really, coming out of the Joker. I was lucky to get a little bit of a run on him around the outside of the bowl turn, and I got on the inside on the next one, and he did a great over-under. I literally saw in my mirror him skying it, and I was like, oh, man, this is going into the door. I thought he was going to take me in the hairpin. And I just got in there a little bit deep and went wide, and it's so slippery out there. He made a nice pass on the inside. I don't even think he maybe touched the front end, but I don't think he really hit me. And yeah, so that was all me. So we don't move on to this next round. I don't know exactly what that means for tomorrow, but it probably means more driving and hopefully it's a good show. It's always fun to race Arpin, so it's a good time. I'd rather win, but it's still fun.
Out of a few of the guys that we have left, who are you putting your money on?
Well, you know, with this bracket, the starts are so important. And both Travis, Scott qualifying so well is always going to get the inside line on the start. Same with Hansen. So we'll see. Aren't they going against each other? So whoever comes out of that one is going to get the inside line in the final, and that's going to be tough to beat. So I'm going to say it's probably going to be Scott or Hansen on this one. Sorry, Travis.
Welcome back here to Utah Motorsports Campus. And we are getting prepared for our final four battles. We're seeing Pastrana versus that man. That is Steve Arpin, all these gentlemen on Yokohama Tires. Thank you to Yokohama Tires, the spec tire of Nitro Rallycross and a sponsor of the Yokohama Tires Joker Lap. All right, let's throw it down to Katie Osborne, who's got an update on the double zero.
Well, that double zero of Steve Arpin, we know there were some good battles with Tanner Faust there. I said, how's your car? And he said, leaping awesome. To be aware of here, and one to keep his eyes on is the merge into the jump, and then that turn after the step up. So those are the couple of things he's thinking about as he's lining up.
All right, well, a little static there, but no static for Arpin. Again, a lot of confidence for him. That's kind of what I read into there. What are your thoughts here? Pastrana or Arpin, you put me on the spot as far as who's going to advance on. My money was on Steve. Are you just going to kind of juxtaposition me or what?
No, I think the thing, Steve's pace is awesome, but Pastrana's aggression with the passes on Hansen were brilliant. Ah, and by the way, we had an update from race control. So you remember Pastrana was into the back of Hansen, put him in the wall. We were like, oh, wow. Susan Hansen got on the text straight away. Timmy said immediately, that was not Travis's fault. I had a broken rim on the front, and I stalled up in the tunnel. So great stuff from Timmy Hansen. Super honest about it. Yeah, and that's what we like to see. So, yeah, good lad, Timmy. Nice one.
Yeah, good sportsmanship, giving some clarity to that situation. Again, had a broken wheel, basically balked and threw a wall in front of him. Travis can't go anywhere. He goes in the back of him. All right, there we are seeing that Subaru, the 199 of Travis Pastrana on the far side, that low and bro vehicle of Steve Arpin. The winner going to the finals and 1 point richer. Who's coming out on top? 10-second car from Yokohama Tire Girl leaving the start line. Get out of the way. These gentlemen are going to be flying. And Travis always saying he doesn't have a good start. He has definitely proved himself wrong up until this point. Steve would like to put a stop to it.
Yeah, he would indeed. Travis Pastrana, we know the Subaru's been starting well thanks to that testing. Got to get the reactions right. Ready to race goes out. Here we go.
green light, brilliant start, but then Bolt away from the line. It was a great reaction time for Pastrana, and I thought Arpin had been beaten, but then the Subaru bogged and Arpin just pulled straight out in front. So now, Steve, I think he would ideally like Travis not to go with him. Travis did not joke the last time, though. He went with the lead driver, and he's going to do the same again. So he's doing what he did to Tiki Hansen. Pastrana's going to try and put a pass on Arpin.
Watch this. You talked about the aggression. This is where it's going to show up. Is Arpin going to shut the door? And look at the different strategies here.
He's got him.
Nice and high, drops in, but Arpin could come back. No, he does not. There you go.
That is a super clean pass. That's the cleanest pass we've seen from Travis. That was an absolute banger. Went high, low, got it done, into the next corner and there. So Arpin now has got to decide, does he try and out-tactic Travis by going Joker and do it on lap times, or can he try and pass him? But brilliant move from Pastrana.
Well, is Pastrana going to take the Yokohama Tire Joker lap as well? I mean, the question lies, are they saving it for that final lap? Remember, the winner goes to the finals. Now they're crossing that finish line. The green flag is out. Two laps left to go.
I'm confident that Pinamaki will alternate the strategy here. You have to, otherwise you're out. So whatever Travis does, I think Arpin will do the opposite. He won't go with him. You saw Travis follow Timmy, and in fact, it nearly caught them out because Timmy had a problem in the Joker. And there we go. Arpin goes Joker.
Nice call.
Yeah, 100%.
Nice call. The Yokohama Tire Joker lap being utilized the first time of this pair. Arpin and Pastrana. Pastrana will start gaining some ground here, but how clean is he going to keep it? And how many seconds is he going to separate himself from Arpin?
We should cover off as well, actually, I'm saying about Pinamaki here. If you're new to Rallycross, UC Pinamaki is Steve Arpin's spotter. He's on the radio to him. He's looking at the gaps and telling him, stay calm, take the Joker. Don't try and fight back now. You know, this part of the track's slippery. So similar to NASCAR, the whole high-low thing. Yeah, it's a big gap.
That's a big gap.
Yeah, there should be another Pastrana. So Travis will be waiting, and he'll get a call as well from his spotter. But I mean, he knows he's got to do it this lap. The ultimate sin, of course, is forgetting to Joker.
Right.
Plenty of people have done that. It sounds daft. You're like, surely you can count to five. No, not when you're driving a 600 horsepower supercar. Counting to five is the least thing on your mind.
Here we go. So
straight in.
Yep, Travis does hit the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. 6.6 seconds is the split. If right now, Travis comes out of this and he will have the lead. Arpin's going to try to catch up to him. Look at that. There is about 1.5 seconds between these two gentlemen. Travis Pastrana diving low, then working high, coming back in. Only time he went high was when he went that pass. He started high, dropped in on the inside of Arpin, and he hasn't looked back since. And look at that. Again, Liam Dorn was talking about it. Pacing that step up on purpose to scrub some speed so your momentum doesn't throw you beyond that blue groove. Remember, the winner going to the finals. What do you got?
We're going to have a new TQ here, definitely, because, of course, Timmy Hansen is out. He got the TQ the year he won. Patrick Sandell got it the other year of the two years we've been. So neither of those drivers, clearly, Sandell's not here, and Hansen is out. So Pastrana, could he take the first championship TQ at Nitro Rallycross here? It would be kind of cool, wouldn't it? It would be kind of a good story. The amount of work everybody put in last night, including Travis, to make this track look as great as it looks today. We've seen some brilliant racing in the brackets. Look at that.
Yep, just a shape of things to come going into tomorrow's main event. 10 cars at the same time. This is the pass. So watch this. Arpin takes a lower line, Pastrana takes a higher line, and this exactly was the X factor that Travis had that would definitely get him the win. Arpin clean, but Pastrana more aggressive. He showed his teeth, he showed his claws.
The only way Arpin could have stopped that was to wait ages, almost to park it on the apex, not to allow Travis to go high-low, you know?
Right.
So you keep it down on the apex and make Travis go all the way around the outside. Arpin knows he's coming, so he gets on the gas early, runs deep. Pastrana knows exactly what's going to happen. Thank you very much.
Tries to throw it right in the mashed potatoes, but there is Travis Pastrana going underneath in that Yokohama Tire Joker lap. 6.6 seconds as he entered it. Obviously, when Arpin landed that, gained some ground there, but not enough as Arpin took the Joker on that second lap. And there's Travis Pastrana moving into the finals. The flying squirrel, the plaited one. And I think Travis was listening to me. He's like, Jared, I'll show you, man. You're betting against me. And you went with him. So, Coley, you win that. You win that battle there, buddy. We'll live to see another. Andreas Backerud in the building. Get over here, buddy.
Coming here now. Andreas Backerud just appeared upstairs randomly.
Here's the bracket, how it shapes up. Scott Speed and Fraser McConnell, they will be up next. But Pastrana waits in the wings to see who he's going against. Two more battles left of our first ever Nitro Rallycross bracket battle. So now it's Speed versus Fraser McConnell as Andreas Backerud joins us here in the booth. Look at that.
Speed straight away beats McConnell down towards turn one. Fraser's had a great start so far, but Scott has been doing the testing for Subaru, and we might end up here with a two Subaru fight for the top qualifier spot. We've got Andreas Backerud, who's in the third Subaru, and Andreas, I think you're pretty gutted, I'm sure, not to be out there in the fight.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, like, it's such a cool event, and, you know, I want to go out there and race, you know, and it's a bummer not to make it through the battles, but that's more racing.
Yeah, are you liking this format, this bracket battle?
I do. It's so competitive, so hard. I mean, like, there's ruts, there's dust, there's... You need to win the start.
Yeah.
McConnell's having a look. Sorry to interrupt, Jared. He closed down tidy there onto the back. So McConnell's done what Travis has done. We've seen, I don't know if you've been watching Andreas, but most people have joked when they've lost the start. Travis. He's followed and gone to stick a move on them. And now Fraser McConnell's gone with Scott Speed, but they've got to split the strategy this lap if they want to, unless he's really confident making a pass.
Yeah, I mean, looking overall, Andreas, we have you here in the booth, and we're seeing, and when Liam was up here, he was talking about casing that landing on the step up by design to take speed out of it. That seems like a critical point right there. Not so much even that bank after the big jump, but that seemed to be the case. How is the track transforming?
I mean, it's hard. It's transforming all the time, and you saw Scott earlier. He jokered the first lap, even he was in the lead. I was surprised.
Well, Liam said he was going to do that, and then he thought that Travis would follow him in.
Yeah.
And it didn't work out. So So,
but down into this corner, there is a great opportunity to do an overtake. Like, it's so hard to get the braking point here. So yeah.
Interesting enough, we have a Subaru driver up here. Andrew, you asked me who was going to come out on top. I said Arpin's going to take out Pastrana. And I also said Fraser McConnell was to take out Speed. I feel like Andreas is up here to stab me with a Subaru knife and say, Jared, we'll show you. But I'm sorry I bet against you guys. I just was calling like I saw him. Arpin's been really clean. His car, the way he's gripping up and getting the car to rotate. And Scott seems that slowing down, slow is fast almost.
Yeah, slow is fast sometimes. I mean, he have a very neat driving style, and it's working. I mean, it's awesome.
How are you doing for settings with these guys? Is there anything that you could, like, do Travis or Scott have a similar style? He's going
to
get it here.
It's very
hard
to
say. Door.
Because if you're not on the track at the same time, it's going to evolve so much. It's super hard to know and understand. And, you know, there's rocks and so much stuff to take care of. I mean, it's very competitive, very hard.
I thought Speed was going to go a bit deep there. And Fraser was so tidy on the inside. Been really impressed by Fraser McConnell. But Scott Speed, a legend of American rallycross, certainly. And coming back from a broken back in 2019.
On that very jump.
Yeah, on this jump, he's going to book a spot in the final with his teammate, Travis Pastrana.
Subaru in the announcer's booth, and Subaru 1 and 2, Pastrana and Speed. So again, I think they're just doing it to spite me, saying, Jared, you're dumb. You don't know what you're talking about. We'll show you. And again, Andreas is here to seal the deal. And Andreas, get your hands. Andreas, I'm sorry. Stop. Please stop. Backerud, please don't. It hurts. So it's an all Subaru final, Pastrana and Speed. You called it, Coley. You went against me.
You know, sorry, dude. Yeah. That's the way it goes.
Yeah.
It's going to be a long season. Don't worry, mate. I make plenty of mistakes. And, you know, you just got to go for it, haven't you? You've got to go for it. And we had our little bets. Betting on rallycross, that'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Well, yeah,
I've never done that.
Says the man as well, who would just definitely have lost two bets immediately.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, anyway. Andreas, overall, it's great. It's weird to see you in a Subaru suit.
It
looks good on you. You look great. And anywhere you can find a steering wheel and a shift knob and a handbrake, you'll be there, right?
Yes, absolutely.
And that was the thing I remember early on. I mean, Nitro Rallycross did a great Insta video of you putting that video up. You're like, anybody want to hire me? Like, I'll drive like anybody. And here you are.
Yeah, I mean, like, to be a motorsport driver is very hard. Like, to get jobs around, it's not easy, and especially during COVID times.
Yeah.
And motorsport and car industry is going more and more electric, so very, like, unknown times we're having right now. So I mean, it's just awesome to be here, and great chance by Subaru.
Well, it's great to talk to you, but we're going to talk to two winners, Andreas.
Thank you.
I'm joking. I'm throwing it down to Katie. I love you, Macaroon. I love you so much. Let's throw it down to Katie, who's with our finalist, Speed and Pastrana.
Yeah, Andreas, we're glad you're in the booth there because this is all about Subaru down here. You can see Travis and Scott really talking through. More importantly, Travis is like, yeah, who would have thought? Two Americans in the final. I'm going to sneak in here. Travis, first for you. How stoked are you that Scott is who you're going up against?
Dude, this is absolutely amazing. Subaru's worked so hard. Scott has literally mentored and coached and helped me. He's given me a lot of flack, and he's like, you know what? If we're going to be out there, we're going to be a team. It helps so much if we can control that front row. And I owe all this to Scott, and now I'm going to go beat him.
A tire puncture, a gearbox issue, and Scott, what do you think Travis has taught you here today? We know a couple of times he's been in your ear.
Well, I mean, he's tried to teach me how to jump, but it just hasn't really worked. He's just really good at it, and there's time to be made on those. I mean, they're like corners. I still have more to learn, but you know, I got my strengths, he has his. We're gonna throw it out there and hopefully not get in trouble from the bosses. Either way, we're gonna have fun.
That's exactly right, and that's what this is all about, right, fun?
It has been a lot of fun. I apologize to Tim, he was a little aggressive, but if I take both of us out, I think the team's gonna kill me. So we'll have fun, though, it'll be good.
All right, guys, that's the energy down here. We're all looking forward to it.
I love the fact they're trying to play down, there won't be any contact. Like Travis has made passes on like everyone in there. Andreas is here in this Subaru race. I wanted to ask you what Subaru means to you, because to me, like, my heroes were Colin McRae and Richard Burns, Solberg as well. You know, yeah. You're in one of the most iconic race suits here. Like, how's it feeling, dude?
I am, and I mean, like, you know, I was growing up 2001, starting with karting. Peder Solberg was the name. He was, you know, hitting the ramp. 2003, he won the world championship in WRC with a Subaru, and it like took off in Norway. It was a big thing, and you know, the history of Subaru in motorsport is huge. So yeah, for me, it's a big thing.
And the color scheme on the car, dude, it's the proper factory color scheme. You know it what is. I mean? It's the proper with the yellow. You know, it's so awesome.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's incredible, and you know, to be here at this venue, it's just like mad. You know, we have done world championship many years, but I've never ever seen anything like it.
79 events done now, though.
79,
both of us, but Nitro Rallycross.
But who's keeping count?
Yeah. You know, Nitro Rallycross now.
Yeah. New times.
Yeah.
I love it. Andreas, what do you think of the bracket battles? The format, now we go, you know, you're sitting out, you got your two Subaru teammates. Yep. Overall, I think it slowly progresses, right, through the weekend?
It does, and I'm excited to see what Travis is going to do now, because he has been speaking about the left line a lot. So I'm excited to see turn one, if he's actually going to make the left line and see if it's faster than the big jump. So yeah,
all right.
You're comfortable you can get it done? Like, you're seeing these guys up here, there's still plenty of opportunity for you tomorrow. It must be good to know the car's got it. And if it didn't go your way today, it's still, you know, we've got a lot of racing tomorrow.
I mean, to be honest, I'm not 100% sure about the format. I go when the team tells me to go, and I try to race as hard as I can.
Tomorrow, you know? Now the truth comes out. When we come back, we are going to be seeing our finals. Also, we got another special guest up here, the golden child, Tanner Faust, joining us up here in the booth. Thank you so much to all the racers. When we come back, our finals will be here. Round one of Nitro Rallycross. Welcome back to Utah Motorsports Campus. Cars that fly, literally, figuratively, and now we got a gentleman up here joining us. He's going to watch the final round with us. Travis Pastrana, Scott Speed. These gentlemen are one-time teammates of our next guest. He's joining us up here, but it's an all-Subaru, all-American battle in the finals. Points were earned. 4 points overall by Travis and Scott. And think about it, Scott, he only had 3 battles because he had that number 2 qualifying position.
I think this will be the 4th point. So I think whoever wins this will get. So basically,
terrible math, not my strong suit.
Dude, me either. If you're not good at live maths, we're really screwed because I'm terrible at it as well. So that'll just be fun for everyone. So yeah, whoever wins this will effectively be the first championship leader for Nitro Rallycross. They're going to get 4 points there. So we've got Tanner Faust up in the box with us. Tanner, how's it going?
It's going good. I mean, you should be used to the bracket format. Right?
Yeah. I was like, this is so familiar.
He's like, oh, so what happens with bracket number 2 when it goes, yeah, whatever. It's literally like, what, exactly. 14, 12 years or something?
18, but who's keeping count? Yeah, your mouth's dropping. You got to be tired, man. You've been traveling all over. I mean, you're flying your own plane, but you're in Europe. You're filming, you know, films, and you're doing all the stunt drive. I mean, you're slim.
Way to turn me right into the bad guy.
Why are you the bad guy?
And you can never, it's never okay to fly yourself to work. And I didn't. I didn't.
I know you didn't. I'm saying you're flying all over.
It's a tractor with wings. It's, you know, it's a...
Yeah, it's all good. I don't think you flew it to Europe, did you? I mean, that's pretty wild if you did.
That would be pretty wild.
Fair go.
No, just got back from Germany. Was shooting a movie with Keanu Reeves. It was absolutely a blast.
Solid name drop.
Yeah, there it is. KR.
And, you got it like that? You just call him KR? What up, dog?
No, it was an amazing project and got really involved in all the stunts and had such a good time over there. But yes, it was a very quick turnaround, straight after work, went on a plane, got off the plane, into the car, and here we are.
Awesome. Well, stick around. Watch the finals here. We'd love to hear your insight on the course here and what's going on, how the course has transformed, and what you think of the course overall. And, of course, your competitors. You're going to be seeing, hopefully, again, 14 vehicles, but we're only seeing 10 in the finals. And right now, it's all about that of Scott Speed and Tanner Faust. Andrew, what do you think? Who's coming out on top?
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. This is the first time we've seen the two Subarus go up against each other. We know they've done all this start testing. Scott did a bunch of that. Does it give him an edge? You know, left, right side of the grid. Andreas Backer was saying they think there's something in that. So here we go. Pastrana versus Speed on the run to turn one. Look for the green. Great start by both of them side by side. Scott Speed's got the edge on Travis Pastrana, going to run him out wide. Pastrana going to go all the way around the outside. And we see Pastrana is the only driver who's not given up if he loses the start. I'll guarantee you he goes with Scott here.
But keep in mind that he said, the team owner says, don't crash out. We know it's your fault, Travis, if they get into a tussle. Both of them going for the big gap here as Scott Speed has the lead. He's got the clean air. Pastrana getting some dust in his face. Let's see what kind of lines he takes. There goes Travis. See if he can dive in like he did on Arpin.
He's going to try the same move, but can't quite get there. Speed carries a little bit more speed around the outside line. Pastrana, though, in the Duke Roost there, completely blinded. But he's right alongside. Speed gets on the brakes. Pastrana rotates the car earlier. Side by side, fighting for traction. Speed just got this. He's so close.
Yeah, amazing execution there. Tanner, we're going to bring you in here. Talk about the course, if you will, how it's transforming. Again, it worsens, right, as more cars are on it. How is it, you know, with a fresh, groomed course compared to when it gets thrashed on?
Yeah, once it gets thrashed on, you got to watch out for the little holes. You can actually see them in the track. You see that blue groove? Looks like there's a lot of grip. There isn't. It's like silt on top of the blue groove. It's amazing amount of discipline for these guys to stick it so close to the tire barrels, especially on the hairpin, which I blew, and don't bring it out there. It's done. We said it. Tires.
Yeah, Pastrana clips the tires. He's gone with Scott again, so he's done exactly what he did with Timmy Hansen. He's not alternated the Joker strategy. He's going to try for the pass. He goes deep and high on the brakes. Almost clips the rear corner on the tires on the end of the K-rail. Now clips the inside. That's game over. Scott Speed should take this. But Tanner, great to see Pastrana. He's like, no, I'm not going with the Joker. I just want to race this out.
To send it that high in the bank now when it's so dry and when there's holes, it's a 1 in 3 chance that you're going to break something up there. I have a feeling that he's probably got a bit of a puncture. But again, you know, he's still pushing, and the Joker has a bit of a hole in it. It's actually treacherous coming out of the Joker. It sends you into the wall on the outside.
We saw you lift your front wheels as you came in. There's almost a crest on the exit, but there's a hole before, or?
There's a full-on crest and a hole right before that, so you actually have to kind of pitch it in the tunnel to get the nose to pop up that crest so it doesn't send you into the wall.
Talk us through, because we're going to see the two cars come through. Now, Tanner Faust watching the two Subarus. Watch for the exits here.
It's a blind entry in here. You see a stack of tires. You pitch it around there. You hope you don't slide too much on the way in. But now you need to start sliding to get the nose over the hole. Scott, very conservative there, knowing that he's just dusted Travis out. And Travis, unfortunately, right now, he's going to try everything, but it looks awesome.
I think this, now he's just having fun with it or trying to try different things, right? That's an opportunity for him to say, okay, this is how the course is going to be tomorrow, mind you, plus 9 more cars, including his, potentially, hopefully. That's what he's hoping for.
Scott Speed come around towards the finish line now. Had an absolute shocker here. Remember, in 2019, he broke his back on this very jump. This time, he will land the jump. He's going to blast down towards the finish line. And our first ever top qualifier for Nitro Rallycross is Scott Speed ahead of his teammate, Travis Pastrana. That is some comeback. There's the team. Big hand for them. Speed, your TQ.
Yeah, Subaru 1 and 2. Congratulations to Scott Speed. Like you said, breaking his back here on this very course. Coming back, he's an inch and a half shorter, but he comes out on top. Tanner, what do you think there?
I mean, you hate to not be there, right?
Right.
But for those two guys to do it is awesome. Scott coming, you know, overcoming. I know he's got some PTSD from that whole experience, and he's talked about it.
Yeah.
Also, Travis has never really had a huge amount of success at his own event.
No.
So, you kind of want to see that.
Yeah, you do. You do.
It but second place. First place loser.
Right. It's good enough.
I wonder if Pastrana would have got harder into it if it wasn't his teammate. What do you think?
Maybe. Maybe. You know, the thing when they're both the same color, you can't tell.
Where the paint's been swapped. Yeah, it's just blue on blue, basically, isn't it? Like, it would have been a blue on blue incident. Look at that landing as well. Pastrana's taken that left side of the jump and landed on the two right wheels several times. He went for the high-low, but watch speed here. So speed, where Arpin ran the car just a little bit too high and he got underneath. He's just carried the speed, hasn't he, the way through the berm.
Yeah, that was a very interesting line that Scott Speed took. It was kind of low to high, right? He worked it out, and that didn't allow Travis to kind of dive in, and then they alternated, potentially alternated positions there. But overall, to Travis's point, anybody could win, right? I mean, looking at this field, I think, Tanner, you're the least familiar with, or no, I guess Arpin is, but the way he's getting that car to rotate is very impressive. But, you know, hats off to you. You're jumping this car. You're very not familiar with this car at all.
No, it's a new car. I mean, at some point, it's got a steering wheel and four tires, so it's like somewhat familiar, but... Yeah. Just how to start the thing in the pits and how to do a launch. Like, did I push the right buttons there? Do I have the anti-lag on? You know, there's a lot of little sequence things with these machines.
Those are the familiarity things as well, aren't they, which take away some. You know, if you need 100% concentration to do something with the Beetle, you knew it off by heart. So I guess there's always that 10% in reserve to think about other stuff, which you maybe don't have now in the same way yet.
For sure. And also how hard you can push it into this stuff. You know, like, you know, there are weaknesses and strengths with all of these cars. So it's knowing, you know, can I really back this thing in and, you know, without damaging something? And do I have, you know, an advantage over these guys on forward grip? I noticed that the Audis are very, very quick on the tarmac. There's not a lot of tarmac, but we've always been quickest on that one turn.
Yeah, that small little section. Well, as you see the two gentlemen talking down there, we're going to throw it down to Katie and talk with our winner, Scott Speed.
Yeah, Scott Speed, Travis Pastrana down here debriefing after that race. Congratulations, overcoming that PTSD. How'd you change your mindset here earlier to kick off a day like today?
I mean, when I'm in the car, I try to just compartmentalize it and drive well. But this was so cool because this is like such an awesome format, the battle qualifying. Last night I had to call my wife and have her send me a drag racing bracket because all my in-laws drag race. They're all in NHRA, they're all champions. I'm gonna count this as my first drag race bracket style. So pumped to bring it home with the win. Thank you so much. I know everybody at home's watching. Love you guys. Well, Subaru 1-2. Awesome. Can't say enough to come back. I mean, this is my first racing competition back from the Boken back. It means a lot to come back with the win, starting in the right direction for the weekend.
Overcoming a whole lot of challenges with that. But you and Travis were debriefing, kind of like walking through a strategy that you didn't know was happening. Walk me through that.
I mean, Travis's driving style is a bit different than mine, and he's really good on all the jumps. So where I can maybe pick up a little time in the technical stuff in the corners, he can pick up time in the jumps. And, you know, we work really well together, so we're always helping each other and getting better. And that's why, ultimately, you got two Subarus up here, because the team, our Subaru Motorsports USA team, is so good, and it's such a team. Everybody works together so well. It just it makes our job easy.
No doubt about it. It wasn't quite a victory here today, but it was definitely a win in Scott Speed's book, especially overcoming some of those challenges. I'm going to make my way over here to Travis Pastrana, who's all smiles. The guys in the booth were saying, hey, would you have gone a little harder if it wasn't your teammate? What did he have on you?
No, I mean, Scott Speed, he's really good. I've been trying to do my best to learn from him. He's really crafty as well. So he went wide and slowed up. He knew I couldn't get inside, but I was like, oh, he's going Joker. So I backed my turn up. And then he just took off and went for the jump. And I was like, already committed to not doing the Joker. So he's good. I knew I couldn't beat him straight up. So I had to take the race to him. And he backed me up enough where I couldn't get around that I didn't have a chance to jump in there. So he's smart. I learned what his technique is. And I'm going to use that in the future.
Hey, so we kicked off today asking you, how much sleep did you really get last night? Do you think you're going to get a few more hours tonight now settling into this race mode?
No, absolutely not. I got to go back to track guy now. I mean, the crews, they have it. Honestly, I probably just slow them up, but there's still a lot of things that we can do to make this track more raceable, more exciting, and even better for the crowd. So definitely excited to make it to where we have. Super pumped. Subaru, Yokohama, KMC, like Red Bull. Thank you for supporting it. All the other drivers that came out that flew from all over the world to be here to be a part of this series for the first year, it means the world to me.
We'll let you go put your construction badge on there. Congratulations, Travis Pastrana, wearing so many different hats this weekend, but still smiling as he makes his way through it.
Thank you so much, Katie. Again, congratulations. Yeah, to all the competitors. And this is what was at stake. Every bracket battle they won was 1 point. So again, earlier I said, oh, both these guys get 4 points. No, Scott Speed, he is your current Nitro Rallycross Drivers Championship points leader. 4 points.
Yeah, and Travis Pastrana, the Nitro Rallycross mastermind in P2. Arpin in P3 with that debut with the GRX Lowenbro car. Fraser McConnell up there equal on points with Arpin as well. That's great for the Jamaican.
Yep. And with 1 point, Tanner Faust, he is just surging right now. All joking aside, Tanner, thank you so much for joining us up here, buddy. Good luck tomorrow, man.
Hey, thank you guys very much.
Yep, appreciate I appreciate it. And look, this is your heat, Tanner. So where are we at, Tanner? So you got Pastrana, Arpin, Faust, Oliver Bennett, Andreas Backrud, Robin Larson, and Cabot Bigham, and then obviously in Heat 1, Speed, McConnell, Hansen, the Hansen boys, Erickson, Doran, and Erickson. So Erickson and Hansen, what do you got?
It's not too bad. Inside line on row 2?
Yeah, no, that's not too bad. There's a lot of cars. Yeah. A lot of cars. You saw how crazy it gets with just 2 cars. 7 cars is going to be gnarly.
Yeah, and then 10.
And then 10
if you make it in.
Yeah, if you're not first, you're last. That's what we're doing here, right?
Oh, man, I love it. Well, thank you so much, Tanner, and good luck to you.
Thank you, guys.
And good luck to your team. But when we come back, we'll put a bow on this thing because it's only day one of 2 days. Here's a few messages from our sponsors here. Round one of Nitro Rallycross here at Utah Motorsports Campus, Utah Sports Commission. Thank you so much, O'Reilly Auto Parts, Yokohama. When we come back, we'll put a bow on it.
I am the trusty co-pilot. The moving part that moves all 2,000 parts. I am the translator who interprets the road. The permission to take the scenic route and the guide that gets you there safely. I'm not just any tire. I am a Yokohama.
We're here for the perfectionists. The champions of doing things right. Whether they're in the shop or in the driveway, they trust O'Reilly Auto Parts. Because good enough won't cut it here. For over 60 years, we've been helping perfectionists get exactly what they want and exactly what they need without compromise. Turning that problem into a problem solved. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Professional parts people.
All right, thank you so much to Utah and that Sports Commission. And Andrew, what a day. What a great day. You know, kicking things off with qualifying, the practice, Sierra cars, right? We crowned a winner. We'll see them tomorrow again and next. And we're seeing those vehicles and those drivers really step up. And, you know, they have aspirations of doubling the horsepower and just their overall build. But then we see our first ever bracket battle. Scott Speed beats him. Himself, you know, because basically, like you said, he wins his first ever drag race. But again, PTSD breaking his back here, that's got to be monumental.
100%. It was huge. He properly hurt himself.
Yeah.
He really badly hurt himself. And he's come back to the same track, to the same venue, having not done any rallies. None of us, 2 years we've waited for this, yeah. Thanks to the rubbish that was 2020. And I just think, you know, all the ideas, Travis and his big dream to turn this into a series. They wanted to do it for a while, and here it is, the series. Instead of one round, we've got five. We're doing this again next weekend. I mean, don't go anywhere, because we're going to do this again tomorrow.
Yeah.
But then in 1 week's time, we're going to do it again, and then 3 more times. And I don't know about you, but I just feel stoked that everything's underway and everyone's having a great time. The drivers are loving it. We hope you guys at home are loving it too.
Absolutely. Again, Minneapolis, Minnesota. So buy your tickets or tune in. Wild Horse Motorsports Park in Phoenix, Arizona. We'll be out there. Southern California, Glen Helen Raceway. I mean, that's on any given Sunday, right? On any Sunday. Come on, day in the dirt. And then finally, anything's down in Florida. And I think I'm going to bring my whole family on that trip. And that's just the culmination of not only this series, but so many different motorsports events and COVID. And it's going to be celebratory at the firm. We'll crown our first ever Nitro Rallycross champion in Miami. Laurette Nichols, she's been a great addition too. She's hosting all the social media stuff. Yeah. I mean, we're really keeping the communication high, and they really want to have fun with this.
Hashtag is Go Nitro, by the That's way, right. If you want to get involved online, obviously Nitro Rallycross as well. Give us a shout. Myself, Andrew Curley, Jared DeAnder, you can get hold of us. You know, we're up for interacting with you guys. Totally. Let us know, what did you think of the battle brackets? Did you enjoy today? I hope you did, because I say, we've absolutely loved it. That man's loved it as well. And, you know, he jokes about the track prep, but he'll be out there. I know he'll be out there checking it all out. Yeah, awesome. Awesome.
Yeah, and you could see him right there, the 199, and you talk about just how committed he is to the growth and the progression. And you know what? Let's just take a little piece at what this really means for Travis.
My name is Travis Pastrana from Annapolis, Maryland. I drive for Subaru Motorsports USA.
Side by side jump here, maybe over the big hit. Both the Subarus, amazing.
Travis was hoping for, and they beat Ekstrom into the turn. But
I got into action sports through my parents. They both love motorcycles. I started racing, then I loved rally, got into car racing, freestyle motocross, and now rallycross. When we're going to all the tracks, I'm making sure that I'm not putting anyone on that track until I've jumped all the jumps, until we've worked out all the damages, all the pitfalls, all the breaks. And I'm very fortunate to be with a company of Subaru that is taking a lot of money that no one will ever see and investing it into building this series. It's been a wild ride. We have three tracks to build, and we're going to get it done, and they're going to be absolutely amazing.
And you know what happens when Travis Pastrana thinks of things? Well, they become big, and they become exciting.
What's up? I'm down here with Travis Pastrana. Hey, what's this? What happens when you get these kind of race stripes on your car?
Well, if you get those type of race stripes and then don't go on to the next round, you get yelled at. But as long as you go on, my team's kind of okay with it in general. I do have a little more damage, going to need some duct tape, but it'll buff out on this side.
So duct tape really is the tape that holds this whole thing together. Is that not true?
For Nitro Circus, yes. For Subaru Motorsports USA, I sure hope not, because these are pretty amazing cars. Definitely excited with the whole day, and huge thanks to Red Bull, huge thanks to Yokohama, Subaru, and all the drivers that came out. I mean, this for me, this means so much. I'm really excited and really surprised we made it as far as we did. One-on-one racing is a little different because how the tracks are built, the fast line is not necessarily the easiest to block.
Well, going into tomorrow, game changes. There's a lot more cars on the track, a lot more opportunity for carnage and excitement. What's your game plan going into tomorrow?
No, definitely these battles are, I mean, in my favor, for sure, because it's one-on-one. I feel like we've done a lot of work with the starts. It is like a space shuttle launch. I mean, I almost stalled it on the race against Arpin. You feel like an idiot, but at the end of the day, they've got it right on that razor's edge, and I'm excited. I think, you know, Scott's helped us get this Subaru. It's such an amazing car, and, you know, it's a little bit bigger car, so when it's super slick, it has a little more stability. We'll see tomorrow. The track's going to be a little bit more groomed, more watered, more traction. It's going to be a completely different race.
Well, all in all, I mean, it's not that much damage. Just keep the shiny side up, and I think everything will be fine.
I agree.
All right. Todd's having some fun there, and he's a great addition to our broadcast. And, again, thank you to Katie Osborne and Todd Richards. And, you know, overall, the bracket battles seem very familiar to me, right? The bracket battles are kind of like drifting, right? So you go head to head, and Travis says he likes that format, a little easier one on one. But with those heats, we got that many cars, 7 and 7 in each heat 1 and heat 2, and then how many vehicles advance on again?
2 from each heat race. So we've got 2 heat races first of all tomorrow morning. There's going to see 2 drivers go through from each of those. So that puts 4 straight through to the final.
Yep.
Then we go on to the semi-finals, at which point there's 5 cars left in each one, and 2 of each of those will go through as well. So that gives you then your 8 cars through, and then you can see we've got the LCQ, which is the O'Reilly's Auto Parts LCQ tomorrow, and that'll be for Supercar. That's about 4:45 Mountain Time, local time that is, and that will put the last 2 drivers through. So 10 of the 14 will go through. I think one of the things I enjoyed about today with the battles as well was the fact that you know, you're fighting your way all the way through. If you had a terrible qualifying, don't forget qualifying two, then solo qualifying. These guys have been racing in different ways all day long, but they still had a chance to win the battles and go through. We've got the same tomorrow. There are plenty of chances to see your favorite driver make it through to the final.
Yeah, and we got a Nitro happy hour. The Pit Viper boys are joining us out here. I got something special. I'll stretch it out for you. Andrew, awesome day. Thank you so much. First event we've ever done together.
Yeah, man.
And it seems like we've been doing this for years.
Likewise. Yeah, me and Jared have come close to working on stuff in the past and never before. And you know what? If there was ever going to be a job which we were going to have fun working on together, it was Nitro Rallycross. So big thanks to the whole team in the background as well. We've worked so hard these last few days to make this happen. Finally, 2 years later, we're underway. And yeah, I can't wait to get stuck into some more.
That's right. Thank you so much to Todd Richards, Kate Osborne, of course, Andrew Coley, and our whole team. We'll see you tomorrow. Tune in 2 o'clock for our pre-show here at Utah Motorsports Campus as round one of the Nitro Rallycross Championship continues tomorrow from here in Utah. I'm Jared Deanda. Send it.
Over the jump.